Greg Popovich, he didn't hold back in his assessment in speaking with us. He says, look, our team got punked by the Clippers.
Here's Durant on the breakaway.
Victor Wembanyama in action. When Victor was living in France, because of the time change, he didn't get to watch a whole lot of NBA games live. But he watched hours and hours.
This is the last possession with Kevin Durant going against Wimby. Quick hands. And this is what Popovich told you and I, B.A., about.
I think he watched everybody. He said he could be such a versatile player in this league. He seems like a historian and someone who follows basketball beyond his era. As he sinks one from three, as Wemby watches in awe.
Tapped in with a few NBA teams as they came through Los Angeles, but different go-around for him as Kevin Durant.
And it looked like that ball hit the side of the backboard.
Three-point shooting around 25% on this young season.
Look at this. Victor guarding KD out on the perimeter.
And the block shot. Blocks Allen. He's on the run. There's a clear, fast break in progress here. And Gordon.
Number 16, Jenny Osmond.
In the lane. Blocks with the left hand. Early part of the season, more comfortable with that one-hand free throw.
It's the way Allie LaForce used to do it in Ohio, too, as Durant lays it in. What do you have, Allie? Both coming on free throws. He does have three rebounds. Hasn't made a field goal yet. Durant, did he block that? Up ahead, Wembanyama runs.
Love it.
Dreamed about these moments.
Yes.
Wembanyama takes a swipe. Clock ticks to two. The shot clock. Durant up and over. Okay.
This is what people came for. Kevin Durant, a generational type player himself, going against Victor.
For the Spurs, it does feel like the old Spurs days, yes, when they had some of the greatest players in the league going.
Back to his own.
Kevin Durant cashes it in. That's money for Kevin Durant all day long.
Yeah,
Vogel wants more threes. He's going to get that when Beal and Booker return. Don't forget EJ.
Oh, look at this. Look at this.
Kevin Durant. That's gave him a highlight.
Well, that's the second highlight he's had over Victor. He had that fadeaway to end that first quarter, and then the finish right at the rim.
Also had a steal guarding Wembanyama one-on-one. Shot clock is off. Wembanyama goes right by Durant.
Look at this. Wow. This is KD over Victor, right? And then Wimby says, anything you can do, KD, I can do better. But how about with the left hand? And look where he took off from. Oh, I said, there's going to be plays, one or two plays.
That was really the issue with the Suns last season. And then when they ran into the Denver Nuggets, that's Wembanyama. Rains at three, shows you a bit of that shooting stroke. Johnson cooked the Suns last year a couple of times, went to 27 and then 34. Durant, beautiful pass, the fake, give it right back. Durant just playing facilitator right now. He's getting everybody involved.
Blocking him. Nice, unselfish play there by KD.
KD and Nurkic, they're arguing with each other. Durant working around Johnson, finds Nurkic. And Nurkic is altered by Wembanyama and a tie-up. Ooh, we have a nice jump ball here, Wembanyama and Nurkic.
He'll never lose. Okay.
I said, what makes this team special? You've played with a lot of superstars. You know what it takes to win a championship. And he said, we have a lot of talent, but we also have a coaching staff.
Tightened up this game a little bit in the third quarter. 12-point Suns lead. Allen for three. Allen stays hot.
That's the problem.
By Malachi Branham.
Good defense by Phoenix.
You know, Popovich wanted to see more ball movement. Three-pointer is good.
There's Kevin Durant knocking down a three.
Suns led by 20 earlier in this quarter.
Oh, you can't gamble.
Now in rotation. Watanabe for three.
That's the problem. You cannot gamble when you have all these shooters on the floor with Durant.
Eubanks clears another one. Too big of a body in there. Durant kicks it. Watanabe again. It's good. Yuta that's been on point.
7 assists for Durant. And again, Watanabe. That's his third made three on the evening.
Throw it 2 inches above the square. There's only one person, maybe two, Kevin Durant, to go get it at four. Watanabe buries a three. Second made three here.
28, Charles Bassey, third
by Wembanyama. Little high screen and roll. Replace. And then in this block shot.
I do. Thank you. I got a guy if you want to.
Oh, another block by Wimby. Now in transition, up ahead. Throw it up there. Purcell takes it himself.
Pop Teller. All I want you to do is use your length, the block shot, which you just did. And how about this? Run the floor.
Here comes Spurs again in transition.
Ball three would be huge right now.
Wembanyama, offensive rebound. Powers his way in.
Okay, there's my second. Didn't I say he was going to give us two tonight?
Just tip it to himself. There's the contact. Let me just throw it up. Prayer answered.
Many night here in the NBA Sean Corbin.
There's a three.
Wembanyama, oh. No, he finds Osman. Who lays it in?
19 years old. You see
the awareness with the cut. No selfish play here. An easier bucket.
Soon to be checking in here for San Antonio. Durant guarded by Sohan. They clear it out. Durant goes to work.
Money.
Easy money to play Durant with 20 on 9 of 14 shooting. Durant to the basket. Durant lays it in left hand.
Well done. This is the difference when
in the offseason with the new contract.
Durant turns the corner. Some contact. Durant knocks it down. The whistle. Approaching the 1 minute mark.
So you're going to have to run a body at Durant.
Keldon Johnson all alone. Durant goes right by him in a two-handed jam. A milestone for Kevin Durant.
Here's a
27,001 points. Wilt, MJ, Kareem, and Durant. 990 games. Amazing. Wembanyama catch and shoot. He's got it. Big shot for the Spurs.
One possession and a quick two here.
Now the play is disrupted. Pops upset. Nassau's going to have to go on his own. Three-pointer. No good. Wembanyama! It's a one-point game. 6.8 to go.
You might want to call a timeout to advance it.
Oh, Johnson takes it from him. Johnson hangs. Yes! And the Spurs have the lead.
What did I just witness here? They go for the steal. They have never led on.
Here's Jaylen Brown. Played his best basketball in the fourth quarter Friday in the win over Miami and lays it in for the first deuce today.
That's a great example of what you can get against Washington. He's just too thin right now.
Tatum goes to work on Poole. Good luck, Jordan Poole. Jaylen Brown, quick trigger, got it. Timeout, Wizards. Tatum on the drive from the corner, coughed it up. Holiday gets it right back. The full 94-foot game from Boston has been so impressive so far. Tatum drops it home.
I feel like Holiday's like the best loose ball. You know what? I'm gonna say good. I'm gonna say a fun, creative offensive player to watch. Well, he is.
Jaylen Brown, splash.
Good to see Jaylen Brown getting on track, especially early in the game.
Knee surgery, missed his first look. Still in awe of that sequence by KP. Brown through contact and one.
Man, it is all Celtics right now. I mean,
missed the free throws there. Tatum back in there working on Johnny Davis, former top 10 pick out of Wisconsin. And Tatum says, Celtics engaged, locked in, shooting the lights out. Brown's got another. And he looks toward the Celtics bench, fired up. Brown steps back. Oh, baby! This is Jalen Brown shooting the lights out. Better phone Stone, 1-800-540-4100. Another takeaway. It just continues.
I mean, look at him shooting well from outside, points in the paint.
Up to 7 points, he's made his last three field goal attempts. Tatum working on DeLon Wright. Splash. Tatum loses right and buries another.
That's a layup for Jason Tatum.
Five different Celtics have a block tonight. Derek White and Drew Holiday both have one.
Oh my gosh!
Jaylen Brown cannot miss.
But you don't need scoring off the bench. You need guys to do their job off the bench.
Holiday hooks it. Brown has been on fire, and that continues. Brown snatches it. I mean, this is a demolition. Celtics still shooting above 60%. Brown, are you serious?
Go ahead. Give him an El Fuego.
El Fuego is piping hot.
We should be playing 2-for-1 right here.
Boston still on top by 24. Tatum, heard you scout, 2-for-1.
Guards that post. It's starting to see it around the NBA a lot, too.
There's Tatum right on cue and a post up against the smaller Tyus Jones, and he banks it in. You know what Tatum did in the weight room over the summer to get stronger. Brown for three off the kick out from Holiday, and he gets the offensive rebound. Jalen was unconscious from deep in the first half, and now he goes to the hole and scores. He's up to 29 points.
Jeez.
At a certain point, that number will start to go down as they empty the bench, leading by 30 here. Brown pulls it. Bullseye.
This is the pace that the Celtics have to play in.
And then, of course, they bring in Jeff Van Gundy as well as a consultant, so there's so much experience after Joe on this staff. Tatum with a two-hand flush.
Yeah, I mean, that's what you need.
The old wardrobe change at halftime.
Yeah.
Brown got it. 34 for Jaylen Brown.
You're kidding with that, right?
Yes.
I just want to make
Jaylen
sure.
Again. What do you think? They run the pick and roll. White skips it for Tatum. Goes to work against Kuzma. That's too easy.
That Jason Tatum getting downhill.
Again, this would be a game if it were just the Wizards versus Tatum and Brown. 36 for Jason, 36 for Jaylen, now 25 for Jason. The opponent's 46% from distance through two, which is the highest mark in the NBA.
I didn't feel like it was bad defense. You know, the Knicks were shooting out of their mind. Tatum puts it down 100, and he's right at 28. And they're definitely still pacing the game.
Oh, yeah. Nice look. Great cut from Tatum. Porzingis finds him. And one. It's too small. Tyus Jones against Jason Tatum. Right over the top.
So Drew Holiday goes into the screen to get the smaller guy on Tatum.
Murray against Mike Conley from the left elbow.
Nice wide open shot. That's good basketball.
Conley coming up the pick and roll. Murray hits it. A three-pointer for DeJounte Murray. Bogey. Reed all up in him. Murray gets around Edwards and scores. Sort of spurt here to go up 14. Murray jump stop. Hunter for three.
Oh, he does continue.
After the whistle. Sadiq. Murray working on McDaniels. Connects.
And Murray's right now, again, he's in a nice little groove, nice little pull-up mid-ranger.
67-52. Great save, but ultimately picked off. Murray to Hunter. Side out of bounds for Trey and company. Hawks will be home Wednesday night. And Washington invades. How about that? Great effort last night in Milwaukee. Has been on his only one of three Wolves that played for Quinn in Utah. Murray rises up. Rickson, Capella.
Oh, he got out of control on that drive there.
Murray finds Hunter underneath. Edwards pass intercepted by Hunter.
Tough pass.
Ahead, Murray. Nice touch pass. Jalen with a jam. Pella's third. Another look at another impressive dunk here by Jalen Johnson. 90-79 Minnesota. Bogey looking. Here's Murray. He's been the hot man tonight.
And he continues.
Rebound, Sadiq Bey.
Yeah, they're starting to miss shots now. This is good for the Hawks, man.
Murray's been hot, and he keeps it going with a three-pointer to cut it to six. That gives the Ant-Man 25. Murray, though, comes right back at him and scores.
Hey, feed him and fan him. I got
cold. Shoot this baby at about 32, 31. Murray, he's been cooking. He rises up and he hits another.
Ooh, my goodness.
10 seconds to go in the quarter.
Let me tell you, they're not making them shots like they were making in the first half.
Murray.
Heat check.
Oh, my goodness.
Heat check. Got a nice little rhythm. And this is the one to say that you're really cooking.
And there's Murray underneath. He lays it in on a great pass. Completely set up by Trey. His knees makes the play. Trey looking. Finds Murray. DJ will drive it. He'll scoop it and hit it. He could do no wrong. Has joined DeJounte Murray with a hot hand. Murray played the entire second half. DJ turns, pops, connects. Just give him the basketball. One in this building last season. They're not going to win tonight. 3 minutes left. 121-106. Murray looking for two more. Yes! And he's tied his career high.
Audi's starting lineup with Steph, Moses, Moody for Clay. Wiggins, Draymond, and Looney. And Steph Curry opens the scoring.
Well, they started with Herb Jones. Defense, that almost went in. Well, Draymond, this is basically his preseason. His timing is going to come back pretty soon.
Steph Curry barely in his hands and right in the bucket. He drops in a three. So Steph's... Curry one more time. Herb Jones was with him, but not close enough.
Hey, he is putting on a clinic moving without the ball. That was just a simple.
Blue is going to help that guy. It seems like he's ready to score a bunch tonight.
So you can tell where they wanted to improve this year. They're shooting.
Well, when you're 29th in threes, the way the game's going, you got to find guys that can hit threes. Chris Paul's first playing time. Along with Dario Saric. Steph Curry just has that mindset of, all right.
Opener. Steph has got it locked in kill mode. The problem is for Matt Ryan, hey, they're so looking for offensive rebounds. They'll give up some.
I don't know who's playing the four, who's playing the five here between Trace and Saric. Steph Curry! Another three! 16 of the Warriors' 18 points. Five, approaching the midway point of the second. Houston lengthened Dyson Daniels on Steph. He rejects the screen, floats it up and in.
Dyson top of his game. He wants to work inside. Warriors are willing to give up his three ball.
Steph Curry for three, already running back. He knew that was down. And
without the ball, you got Looney there. He's working off of him. Didn't.
Steph on Hawkins, setting up Draymond. And gets it into Looney. Oh, used the rim to protect it, but couldn't finish. Batted back out to Moody. Nine to shoot.
Oh.
Curry had Hawkins fly by him and made the three anyway.
Oh, they wanted the offensive foul. He got a tech on his game. It's paid all the way off.
Such a good guy, too. If you ever chat with C.J. McCollum, he's got a podcast. He's into wine. He's really a very intriguing player. Curry spinning it up and in.
Talk about intriguing. Allows him to do whatever he wants with the ball and his finishing ability.
Last four shots. McCollum, tough shot there, flat. Wiggins batting it up in the air. But Hawkins comes down with it. Matt Ryan. He knew CP3, knew exactly who that was because he contested that wonderfully. Oh, Curry. Corkscrewing it up and in. shimmy shake that.
That was
some contact there. Unfazed, was still able to finish. Saw a little opening. Some of the big guns back in the game. Steph and Zion Williamson back.
And Curry, a little foul line jumper. So he's got 32.
He's not.
The Warriors become almost invincible.
You got to take advantage of it.
He's 11 of 16. They get 12 of 17. Another three, and he's got
confidence. Supreme talent. Look, they just got a little confused there, a little hesitation. Any hesitation.
Here he comes. Oh, step out of the corner. Oh, he got another one. Come on, are you kidding me?
He's knocking it down before you can blink. Zion Williamson is supposed to stay with him so the double team can get there, but Steph shook him so bad, made him run away. That's disrespectful. Look at him celebrate.
Warriors had that very rough shooting night against Phoenix, but they could come home 3-0 on the trip. And Steph Curry puts it up and in. He's got 39. He's
toying with people now.
He's coming out, and he's got a 40 spot. 42 for Curry.
He's special. That's all you can say. Help it. He's a showman.
Last time in New Orleans, 37. Missed four times on back end of a back-to-back. Well, he's back with 40.
That's what makes him tough. He can catch and shoot. Won't be anything easier than that.
You were talking about setting a screen, and Grant Williams set a screen that gave Luka some room to drive. The shot fake that he just put up a moment ago, that was, you know, sometimes there are good shot, not so good shot fakes. That was a very good ball fake by Williams, and that's three times that he has nailed one from deep to start the game.
His attempt from the line.
Now Luka will stop and pop. Quick offense. Three ball is good again. Man, the Mavericks are cooking with grease early in the game tonight.
Beating Portland, because that was one of your best calls ever.
I appreciate it.
No, it was. You were, and he's certainly done some things that I've never seen before. Great pass there to Lively. Good patient by Lively on the roll.
I definitely want Tillman shooting, not Bain, with all due respect. On the drive, step back from the near the top of the key is good for Luka.
The Grizzlies this season, 38% from the three-point line. It's not normally their game.
Smart's now made three. He's got 11 points. Luka right back at ya.
Lively and then Luka with Tillman on him.
Young player, still 19 years old. So much great basketball out in front of him. Luka on the dance floor.
This dude is shooting the three.
And they can work this thing to a 2-for-1. Ideally, they'd like to shoot it at 33 seconds. It came at 31 seconds, but it came from the guy. You want the shot coming from Luka Doncic from a long way away.
I like this. Go right back to the guy that carried you in that second quarter. And he does nothing but what he did in the second quarter.
There is Bane. Shot clock winding down. He got it away.
Good defensive possession.
Oh, and a leak out by Jones and a great pass. Oh, that is a beauty.
And one.
And Luka with a great pass, a whistle and a foul for an and one as well. Luka did.
Yeah, and Jason Kidd is loving this pass. Jones, we talked about how well he's played in this contest tonight. He's one of those guys that can get out in the open court, athletic. Doing a lot of the damage offensively for Memphis.
4-3. It's good, Jones.
Yeah, he just passed his Chicago high.
Kuba screening. He's open. Three-pointer is up and on the money. Man, I'm just happy to see Maxi shoot the ball. He's turned down some shots tonight.
He does. That's Michigan.
Long finish, Kuba. Not just a pick and pop guy, pick and roll as well. Hardaway with a catch and shoot. Deep three.
Touch.
Oh, yeah. Pillow soft touch.
Yes, sir. A lot of support from other guys tonight.
And then sometimes he's there to do things like that. Rainbow.
We
swishes.
Saw a lot of that in the second quarter.
In the second half, Bane is 3-for-6 on the floor. Josh Green nails a three.
Josh Green has found a comfort.
Smart, the defensive player of the year two seasons ago. Jaren Jackson, the defensive player of the year last year, switches on to Luka. Still drains the three. Two defensive players of the year couldn't stop Luka. Defending defensive player of the year, then Zaire Williams. And Luka puts up a shot, and there's calls for an offensive foul that is not going to be called.
Got Murray. Murray's got the matchup. Goes right by Markkanen for a moment. Now Jokic underneath to Murray. What a beautiful dish. Four threes, and he opens with a three tonight. Into Jokic. Nuggets by four. Murray's got it. Collins on him. He should be able to go by him. Now Jokic.
Alley-oop. Yes! Gordon flying early.
Utah, what a terrible pass. Porter. And the tap in by the big tipper, Nikola Jokic. Season where they made the playoffs. Long pass, Porter. Great feed inside to the cutting Jokic.
Always catch the ball in transition. Look to the basket first. And you got a shot and drive.
It is on Jackson. That's his first. Team's third. Now Michael Malone going to sub in Christian Brown. And he replaces Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Jokic going around Collins. Hang on to it. Dumps it in. Hand off to Murray. Murray, and a good back there. And Jokic got it back. Under a minute. Don't forget the First Bank halftime report is coming up. KD, hands and dents are there. Jokic drops in a six-footer. You saw him there about altitude. Whether he would mention it, he said, you know, we play at 4,400 feet. So we're up high as Jokic drills the three. Can pull the trigger right there. He could. I'm going to go two-man game. No. Jokic singled up against Markkanen. Jokic in the lane. Little hook shot. That's good.
They're just not getting into their set. Coach getting a little upset right now.
Hand off KCP. He's got a good look. Nails it.
They're making shots. They're moving the ball. Everything is just tough for Denver right now.
11-2 run. Jokic inside. Yes. Porter, boy, the Nuggets need a jumper, and they get one.
Yes, they do. Well, then it just bumping people.
Porter shoot, Jokic, going to be a hook shot coming in. Softly rolls it home. 87-80, can the Nuggets pull away here? They have some defense. Strip. Jokic has it. Give it to Christian. Christian on the run. Scoop it up and in! Christian Brown. Jokic, 21 points, 8 assists, 7 rebounds. Under the Gordon, who's away. That's good to see. So Aaron Gordon. Nuggets need a bucket. Two-man game. Jokic inside, put it up and in.
Oh, and one.
Basket counts foul.
Well, I think it was as he's going down.
Oh, they call Horton Tucker on it. His fourth.
Oh. That's big man, strong man basketball. Markkanen trying to sell the flop.
Kurtley. Yeah, that's the big number. Seven different players. They can go deep with shooters. Lakers, just six made threes, 26%. LeBron finds Torian Prince after the timeout. Torian goes all the way, hits the bottom of the rim. AD's there to clean it up.
AD with his 26th point and his 18th rebound.
And again, that's just the third and fourth second chance points for the Lakers. They've been outscored in that department 20-4 right now. So couple that with the threes, and that means Magic, I believe, that's off of Suggs. Two-point game, 2:42 to play.
And Lakers got a break there because nobody boxed out Suggs. He just couldn't control it, and they really touched it last.
Jalen out of Gonzaga, the fifth pick in the draft in 2021. LeBron deliberate in the attacking 47. He's got Carter Jr. in front of him. The three and the lead! The three and the lead for the King!
LeBron now up to 19.
It's
the defense where they've got to try to get their mark.
Now the crowd involved too. Suggs to get the lead right back, and he does it. Buries it from the outside.
Well, they make their 14th from that distance. They double the Lakers up.
103-101. James Davis. Got Suggs on him. Now the double comes. Wood finds an open D'Lo. Got it! Got it! Good luck!
First team to get a stop may win this game.
Yeah, you're right. Minute 40. We're in the final 2 minutes. Lakers up by one. Vaccaro goes around James, attacks, can't score. Boy, that hung on the rim a long time. The Lakers have it. Suggs nearly came back and stole it. Suggs is all over the floor. It's taken by LeBron.
Big trip here, big trip here.
Up by one. Lakers lost a heartbreaker last night. Can they win a close one this evening?
Clock, three.
LeBron with two. Deep, knocked down. Carter Jr. has it.
Ooh, it spun around, but look at this. Quick attack.
Fultz going all the way.
Drive and kick for the open man.
Cannot bury it. He was open. And AD got hit in the face.
No, the guy that tried to touch him was out of bounds, who tried to get the ball. As that's just going to be a violation on the Magic. It'll be Laker ball.
LeBron James. Got to get it in, and does, as AD comes to meet the ball at midcourt. Shot clock is at 17. There's 44 to go in the game.
Lakers need to score here. They need to score in a big way.
They're up by just one. LeBron still handling the basketball. Got to get into his action now with six. With five, LeBron James trying to go around Carter Jr. It's going to be up to Wood. Rebound, Davis!
Maybe.
On the floor. Look at this scrum. Look at this scrum.
They called a timeout, Magic.
With Orlando possession. It's a good hustle play.
And only 20 seconds left in the game. So this comes down to one possession for the Lakers defense. Put it in the hands of Christian Wood. He didn't have a choice because the shot clock was just about out. And they got the timeout and were
on the floor. Suggs, Carter Jr., and Markel Fultz, who has the basketball. Shot clock is off. Down by one. All the way. Suggs attacks. Rebound Wood. Are they tying him up? Is it a tie-up or is it a foul?
I think they're calling a foul. Side out of bounds because they had a foul to give. I mean, that's attacking the basket.
Isn't it, though?
Verticality.
Good play by AD.
But the Lakers have to make sure they get the ball inbound to a free throw shooter. D'Angelo would be...
Go ahead.
I was going to say D'Angelo would be first on my list.
Made all three of his tonight. D'Angelo trying to get it in and finds Davis. There's the end
across. You only have
eight.
They didn't. They had the short clock.
Yeah.
But there was only 10 seconds on the clock.
And again, two free throws does not seal anything.
No, because there's still eight seconds. But you need these two.
Yep. You need both, or then every play is an option.
So that the worst thing that can happen to you basically is another OT.
Perfect. He's 4 for 4.
Nice bounce back game for D'Angelo. Didn't have a great game last night, but he's answered the bell in this one. He's got 27 points on 10 out of 14 from the field. You talk about efficient, or do they try to just play the defense without them scoring a three?
And Magic has to be cognizant of that fact, perhaps, and more of a catch-and-shoot situation. And if they need an offensive rebound, they'll get an opportunity. Fultz to Wagner. Wagner is going to try the
short.
Three. LeBron was there, but they've got another opportunity. Suggs to tie the game, and the Lakers hold on and win it.
Boy, I tell you, the Lakers dodged another one. That ball was loose, and Suggs, who seems to be everywhere in this game.
Put in the corner for Vassell. Zone for the Spurs here. And Nurkic lost the handle on the floor. Collins trying to get it to a teammate, and it'll be a jump ball.
Looks like Pop was trying jump to call timeout over there, and I guess the official didn't hear him. But if you're Collins, you've got to win this tap here. So you got a real chance here. It's a three. Are they going to give them possession? Yeah. They gave them possession as well, so they reset the shot clock. Even if they lose this, well, you got to win this tip here.
Collins and Nurkic battled each other for years with the Blazers.
Right to his right, Jones.
And that's a runaway for Keldon Johnson. Gordon just lets him go. Best case scenario for the Spurs. This is a five-point game, Reggie.
Kevin Durant, who's been more of a facilitator tonight, has to go into attack mode now. Back in the zone for the Spurs.
Allen drives it. Okogie gives it right back. Allen spots up. Three-pointer. No. Rebound, Trey Jones. Spurs want to push.
Three for Johnson.
Spurs with their small lineup. Johnson. Brady is fouled. Suns thought he traveled. Johnson's going to the line.
Nurkic won this jump ball, but Gordon didn't even go after it. As soon as Johnson got it, off to the races with the finish here.
Spurs in the penalty the rest of the way. Foul was on Grayson Allen.
And the question, if you're Greg Popovich, is when do you come back with Wimby? He's been on the bench now for a couple minutes, but the smaller lineup helping them potentially cut this to a one possession game if Johnson can knock down this free throw.
Spurs were down 20 at the 7 minute mark of the third quarter. Now they're down three. Suns with the ball. Big possession here for Phoenix.
Back to that 3-2 matchup zone here for the Spurs.
Gordon almost got caught in the air. Gordon gets it back over Sohan. No. Johnson with a rebound. Here come the Spurs. A chance to tie here with a three. Trey Jones, the backup point guard. The small lineup has been very effective for San Antonio. Holding their own in the zone defensively, too. Durant with a deflection.
Here's Link disrupting Vassell.
Allen with the blow-by and run down by Jones from behind.
Nice hustle there by Jones, not giving up on the play there.
Trey Jones' older brother, Tyus, was teammates with Allen on that Duke national championship team.
Missed opportunity there by the Spurs. Another turnover.
3:40 remaining. Nurkic feeling it right now. He's got another one. The big man steps out and drills his second three.
And if you're playing the percentages, he has struggled this year.
Media guy doesn't lie. Johnson goes right at Nurkic. Durant picks it off the rim. Durant pushes. Okogie on the wing. Jones running the floor. Denied at the rim, Okogie. Ball is loose. Durant's got it. What? Nurkic, three? No good. That was the ultimate heat check.
Well, with a hat trick there for Nurkic.
Sohan pulls Durant out. Looking for Vassell, their best scoring option. Vassell, step back, three. Oh! Oh! Looking like Dame Lillard right there.
Cold-blooded step back there by Vassell.
Devin Vassell with 18, 10 in the quarter.
The zone is really distracting Phoenix here.
Allen looking for space, tripped.
Sohan. Devin Vassell, you talk about a cold-blooded step back. Made one earlier in the first half. Same. What a step back there by Vassell.
So next level. Pop is riding with this group.
He was rewarded too, right? In the offseason with the new contract.
Durant turns a corner. Some contact. Durant knocks it down. The whistle. Greg Popovich wants a timeout.
Victor back on the floor here with the Spurs, and you put length on him with Kevin Durant here.
Vassell has been a hot hand. 10 in the quarter.
looking for Wembanyama. Durant's on him. Wembanyama gives it back. Vassell with seven to shoot. Hot pass, Collins. And that is going to be Spurs ball. That might be one to be challenged here. It did look like Collins touched it last.
Oh, no, but it looked like Okogie.
They're going to light the lamp, though. The Suns are going to take a look.
Yes, it would have been off Collins, but it looked like Okogie came in and forced the ball out of the hand of Zach Collins.
2:07 left in regulation. This has turned into a ball game tonight in Phoenix. Big call right there. Spurs ball, six to shoot. Wimby's got to go. Take it on Nurkic. He spins, rises up, passes it, and a foul. Just as the shot clock was about to expire, 0.2 remaining on the shot clock.
Sending Jones to the free throw line.
Spurs in the bonus.
Again, they're not used to having the shot clock on the floor here, so I don't think Wimby knew that the shot clock was running down. There's the foul.
Right as the shot clock was about to expire. Huge break for the Spurs. Jones hits the first free throw. Now, this entire second half, the shot clocks above the goal have been dark. They have been inoperable, so that's why every arena has the backup shot clocks. And you roll them in.
They're giving a delay of game to the Spurs and Trey Jones here.
Greg Popovich was trying to get Sohan in the game. No harm yet. Next one will be a T. Collins is out, Sohan is in. Jones, the backup point guard, into double figures.
One possession again.
Starting five on the floor for Phoenix. So Curry, Durant, Nurkic, Allen, and Gordon. Four of the five for the Spurs with Trey Jones. Ball in the hands of Durant. Taking on Johnson, little fadeaway, no good. Back tap into the hands of Johnson. Here comes Jones. Minute and a half to go. Spurs down three.
High screen roll with Wimby. Your two best players.
Vassell. Tough shot.
Yeah. Great defense there by Okogie. That's what he's known for.
Looked to me like Wembanyama bailed out of the screen a little too early. He was off and running. Vassell was hoping he'd wait for him. Approaching the 1 minute mark.
So you're going to have to run a body at Durant.
Keldon Johnson all along. Durant goes right by him in a two-handed jam. KD.
So Popovich believes that Durant may have gotten away with a travel.
Takes him over 27,000 points in his career. Johnson missed the three. Vassell and Okogie. That'll be Spurs ball. A milestone for Kevin Durant.
Here's
27,001 points for Kevin Durant. Fewest games to 27K. It goes Wilt, MJ, Kareem, and Durant. 990 games. Amazing. Wembanyama catch and shoot. He's got it. Big shot for the Spurs.
One possession and a quick two here. We're in that 2-for-1 situation now.
Spurs do have one timeout.
You want to get a good quality shot here. Here's the steal.
Oh, almost got it.
Sure did.
Oh, Gordon almost lost it. Suns in disarray here. Five to shoot. In the corner. Watanabe. No. Spurs with a chance. The Suns no fouls to give. Three-pointer can tie it.
Watch. Wimby with a three here as well, but he's got to set a better screen.
Now the play is disrupted. Pop's upset. Vassell's going to have to go on his own. Three-pointer. No good. Wembanyama! It's a one-point game. 6.8 to go.
You might want to call a timeout to advance it.
Oh, Johnson takes it from him. Johnson hangs. Yes! And the Spurs have the lead.
What did I just witness here? They go for the steal.
The trigger it in. 1.2 to go. The catch, the shot. No good.
Luka. And the Spurs win on the road for the first time this year.
Wow.
What a comeback.
Here he comes. Yes. Oh, the steal and the jam. He's got 20. We got ourselves a one-point game and a great finish here at the Heat's house. Oh, the Nets with 17 turnovers. Miami has 20 points off them. Well, Butler, Bam, and Hero all at 20 points or better tonight. O'Neal maneuvering. Offensive foul on Royce O'Neal. Some chicken wings this late into the night. I want to eat that one. By the way, the Raptors beat the Bucks tonight, 130 to 111. Toronto shot 56% against Milwaukee. Jimmy miss inside. Loose ball rebound to Cam Thomas with 340 left in the game, and the Nets holding a one-point lead. Hero jumps out on Thomas. Shot clock at 10. Thomas, you know what he wants. Look at that. Finney-Smith missing the three. Rebound, Bridges, and a foul. Bridges snuck inside of Kyle Lowry. That's one former Villanova Wildcat besting another.
Yeah, right. I mean, Bridges has the length advantage over Kyle, and this time does a great job of finding that little gap and then times the rebound perfectly with a strong finish. Everything he does, very quick.
Oh, Bridges to the line, a potential three-point play with Brooklyn up by three. Yeah, I'm intrigued by the Bucks. We just saw them the other night. They lost tonight 130 to 111 at Toronto. Lillard had 15 points. Giannis had 60. Interesting.
It's great for the league. You show up, you play hard, you give yourself a chance.
The Bucks are 2-2. The Raptors ended a three-game losing streak with that win. Meanwhile, it's a four-point Brooklyn lead with 3:21 to play. Bridges has 15 points. Bridges was a standout for Team USA in the FIBA World Championships this summer. Timeout Miami. Share of fourth-quarter problems this year. They're having a situation like that right now. They've been outscored in this fourth quarter 26-14. They need a score here with 3:13 to play, down by four. Hero against Finney-Smith. A bump, a basket, and a foul. It's a two-point game, a free throw coming to Tyler.
Last year that ball was going to Jimmy and that was it. This year, he is confident. Look at that. I mean, he's taking the bump with the finish, and his teammates let him play in isolation in that situation. He knew he had the step, and that was a nice finish off the glass.
Oh, that's his first fourth quarter free throw missed in the last two seasons. 101-99. Miami trails by two, just under 3 minutes left. Bridges against Hero. Oh, the 360 spin, but no score. Bam down with his 14th rebound. Heat need two to tie, three to take the lead. Butler tried for the three. Bam missed on the tip. And here comes Ben Simmons with 2:37 to play. Quick move by Bridges on the baseline. This is O'Neal. Look at Butler track him down and switch right to Cam Thomas with a shot clock at 8. Shot clock at 3. Thomas 4-3. Well, he had the double clutch. Good D by Tyler Hero. Down by 2, but with the rock. Richardson for 3. No. Rebound to Royce O'Neal. Probably not the guy you want dialing long distance right now. Hero 1-for-9 shooting tonight. Heat trail by 2, under 2 minutes left. Need a stop. Oh, not a foul. Kyle Lowry picks up the foul. That's his third. It's Miami's fourth team foul of the quarter.
First team foul in the last 2 minutes.
It was Richardson that missed that last three. Richardson having the rough night at 1-for-9. 2-point deficit for Miami. Bridges against Richardson. Thomas for 3. Ben Simmons bats it out. The Nets get another 14 seconds to work with. Minute 32 to play. Bridges over Bam. In and out. Rebound tipped by Butler to Hero.
Ooh, you had to hold your breath on that one. Tyler on the run, rimmed out. Ben Simmons comes down with his 10th rebound. So Simmons has had 10 rebounds in all four of Brooklyn's games. Nets still ahead by two, 1:08 left in the game. Thomas, Bridges, this is Finney-Smith. He gets to the paint and he scores. Dorian Finney-Smith has been amazing in the second half. All 15 of his points in the second half after a scoreless first half. Nets by four, 50 seconds left. Bam, turning, hooking, missing. And the Heat are in trouble right now.
Way too many empty possessions, right, Eric? You got to get something on offense.
37 seconds left. And a timeout to Brooklyn.
Same guys, right? It's just been a tough one for Miami.
Well, the Heat were last in the league in scoring a year ago. It's not been a strong suit this year. That's a breakaway for Bridges, and that's going to do it. The Heat are down by six with 33 seconds left. They've been outscored 30-16 in the fourth quarter. Hero corner three. Got it. Oh, a desperation three that got nothing but net. 27 for Hero. That's his fifth triple of the game. It's a three-point lead for Brooklyn. And look out. The Nets still have it. Bridges with 12 seconds left on the clock, and the Heat finally foul. Travel. You cannot self-pass.
I mean, that's such a big, big one.
Go 31-16 Brooklyn in the fourth quarter. The Nets with six double-figure scores. Amy, another factor for the Nets. They out. Talk about depth.
And they got into what they wanted to do. 24 fast break points tonight for them.
Well, they've been over 20 fast break points every game. They average 24 fast break points a game. Hero with another triple. Tyler Hero, 30 points. His 20th career 30-point game. 10 of those 30 here in the fourth quarter.
You don't have the luxury of trying to get into a shooter, right? You've got to take the foul right away.
O'Hero, 30 points, 6 of 10 from 3. Bridges makes the first. He's got 20. The Nets by 3. The Heat need Bridges to miss this one, and Miami would need a 3 to tie. By the way, Bridges with 8 of those 20 points in the fourth quarter.
And Duncan coming out of the game for Haywood.
Second by Bridges. It's good. 4-point Brooklyn lead. Timeout, Miami. Well, 34-22 is the tally in the fourth quarter, Brooklyn. Lowry looking inbound, gets it to Duncan. Here comes a three. Short. And that will do it. The Nets come from 16 down late in the second quarter to defeat Miami.
White, right off the catch, knocks down a three. Great pass from Tatum. Great read. Tatum kicks it to the corner, gets it back, gets the dribble back, takes a fallaway three, and nails it. Brown posts up his namesake and knocks it down. I love the balance. Tatum takes it, banks it home with a foul.
T.J. McConnell was not moving, and that's a great job of body control, and we talked about this in the pregame.
Tatum in the paint, will fall away.
Yep. Deep in the bag. Top, just checking off right here, just reading defenses, cross, hit, fake spin, fade, bottoms.
Richie with a nice catch. Kicks it back outside. Tatum four on the shot clock. Hauser for two. Tatum.
Jeez. Grown man. Grown man work.
Tatum.
With the walk back. Yeah. Home run trot.
Takes that ball to baseline. Gets it back. Goes a step back to the corner. And knocks that down.
comfortable going out there and scoring. From step backs to post up.
Oh, Tatum. Oh.
I mean, he just takes his time. He just goes where he needs to. He reads the basket the right way.
Still 3 minutes and 20 seconds in the third quarter. Tatum, a couple of fakes. Baseline. Mm. This is just silly.
I mean, he's designed play. The bonus, 19, 11, and 6. Steph's got a good look at a three. Perfect. Again, he got separation from Keegan Murray coming off of those screens. And the help wasn't ready. There's some Barnes. This is where they exploit that size with Steph and Chris Paul. They're putting Barnes on Chris Paul on the block. Draymond Green is digging down. And Chris Paul coming up with a steal. He's too tricky down there. Is that not Curry? Another three. Rimming out. Draymond the rebound. Looney's got a dunk. Yeah, Draymond screaming on him too. Davion Mitchell was trying to box Draymond Green out. Warriors just showed their mental toughness this game. Keep fighting. Yeah, we're turning the ball over. Just keep fighting. We're not making three. Don't stop fighting. Long way to go in this one. Kevin Huerter setting up Sabonis. An open Harrison Barnes, corner three, rimming out. Rebound Huerter. Chris Paul had to foul him. And again, offensive rebounds by the Kings have killed the Dubs tonight. They were crashing like crazy there. Huerter and Keegan Murray. You don't think of Huerter as a monster rebounder, but he came in there full force, grabbed it. This is the yin and yang of the NBA. There's so many good things about Chris Paul and Steph playing together to try to close, but they're not getting any taller.
Yeah.
And so teams, all right, you want to play two Hall of Fame small guards? We're going to send everyone to the glass all the time.
That's the problem. Even if they're in good position at times, the size wins out. So you got to get more numbers in there, outnumber them inside. Chris Paul and Malik Monk have a little discussion going down. So Huerter hits both free throws. Huerter's 6'7". I mean, to your point. So 1 point game. Steph Curry for three. Off back iron and Huerter another rebound. That's a good play early offense. Just a quick flare screen. Kings are still shooting at 39%, and this time Draymond wraps him up.
Orders are the over the limit, so it's free throws regardless.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. That's big two now. Everything the Kings do, if you foul them, they're at the free throw line.
Well, how do you win a road game when you're shooting 39%? You have the 13 offensive rebounds. You force 17 Warrior turnovers. You get to the line 21 times to the Warriors 15. And these are all little around the margin things that have given Sacramento a great opportunity.
The way the game is gone, the Warriors are still here, though. Still in position to maybe win this game. It's anybody's game now. Clutch minutes. Who wants it? The Kings have spent a lot of time in clutch games. They know what they're doing in those games. Can the Warriors pull this one out? Harrison Barnes, a couple free throws. Just got to make sure you take care of the ball on this side now, though. That three-point lead briefly there and now gone with the Kings up one. Steph Curry on Huerter. These empty possessions will be the undoing of the Dubs if they're unable to win this game. Steph is human. He fumbled that one a little bit there. Passes a little low for GP2, short corner. Steph has 7 turnovers tonight. That just does not happen. Huerter down the lane. And all 5 Kings starters are double figures. Steph had to chase her around, working off of those screens. He's been a threat tonight. So from up 3 to down 3. Double teaming Curry. Draymond the decision maker here. Klay Thompson back to Draymond. Nicely done. Draymond Green with 13 tonight. All the focus on the shooters, even if they're not shooting the ball like they're capable of. Kings protecting that 1 point lead.
Keegan Murray, step on top of him. Shot clock at 7. Malik Monk, what a finish. He is explosive. Warriors got to be perfect this final minute 40. Down 3. And no empty possessions would help. That's a bonus out of the lane here. And then Clay sneaking in to lay it in. Great vision by Draymond. He saw that Kevin Huerter just didn't see the ball. He was topping him. Throw it over the top. Huerter picked up his dribble. Here's Malik Monk again. Sabonis has deep position. Banging and bumping with Draymond and a foul. You can see that one coming. Draymond had to help in recovery. He did it well, but when he got back to Sabonis, Sabonis had great position, and Steph got over there and fouled Sabonis on the arm. These are free throws, 11 and 12 for Sabonis. The Warriors have taken 15 as a team. He's done his job, but again, it's balanced scoring for the Kings. 6 Kings in double figures. No one over 20 points yet. And Sabonis, who had been 5 of 10 free throwing, drops that in.
Warriors are going to at least have a few possessions left. So you're going to need to get a stop or two.
Sabonis, 20 points, 11 rebounds, 6 assists, 6 of 11 from the line. This is the way the West is. No easy nights, even if key guys are out. And he drops them both in. You don't need a 3 this trip down, but you got to be perfect to finish this off. 2 minutes, Steph. Payton at the foul line. Payton floating up and in.
Yeah, he's got to attack there in the middle. They're going to keep double-teaming Steph, try to take him away. Someone else has to step up, be ready to attack.
Sabonis up top. Inside the final minute. Kings clinging to the one-point lead. Shot clock down to 7. Malik Monk attacking Draymond. Hanging, had it blocked out of bounds.
2 seconds left.
They get it out to Harrison Barnes. 1 to shoot, knocked away. And that will be a 24-second violation. So the Dubs do it defensively. Now where do you want to go offensively?
That's a big stop there. So you know they're probably going to double-team Step. He's got to be ready to get rid of it. Maybe relocate. You can try to get it back. But if you get a chance and he gives it up quick, go ahead and attack. Don't be afraid of it. And Klay Thompson, you still got him on the floor. If you're double-teaming Steph, he's got to be a threat as well.
So Davion Mitchell in for defense. See multiple guys hounding Curry, and so Chris Paul comes to get it. Now Steph's got it.
And they can do 2-for-1 if they want.
Curry behind his back, runner for the lead. Rimmed in!
That's perfect. Just what the doctor ordered. Now one stop.
25 ticks left in the game, 17 to shoot. Warriors up 1. Everyone on their feet in chase. Malik Monk working on Payton. Sabonis for the lead. Banked it in!
Wow.
Shot clock off. No timeout. Everyone running to Curry. There's 3 Kings there. Gets it to Draymond, down to 5. Klay Thompson at 3. Klay for the win. Good!
Klay Thompson is still out there.
Davis in Harrison Barnes' face to make this pass difficult. So here we go, throwing it up. It's got to be tipped in, and the Warriors win it.
Following season, but Leonard 100% right now, according to the coaching staff. A steal, Reeves in transition, hits James, and LeBron puts it in off the window. Percentages to win the West went way up after the Harden trade, according to ESPN Analytics. They now have the greatest chance of winning the West as James gets his second basket, just his 4th shot of the first.
But it's still off. He's got 1 shoe on, right? You know, need your shoes to play back. I mean, as great as he is, still need 2 shoes.
And here he is with the throwdown. Put on the shoe, race the floor, get the pass.
Well, this is a good trick here. Take your shoe off. Nobody guards you. Sprint the floor.
halftime.
Here's James. He's taken just 5 shots here in the first half, looking to distribute a lot more than score here, but able to get to the basket and bank it in. He's in double figures now, the first Laker to hit 10 points. His efficiency, for whatever reason, as a starter, and we don't know that he's going to continue to start when Harden comes back, but came off the bench of the Lakers, was not efficient. Went to the Clippers as James answers for 3 and looked like a much different player than he was with the other team in LA.
I think he has earned that right. And he's also shown last year with the Lakers, he will come off the bench, and he'll be very effective coming off the bench. There's an easy basket. That's the Lakers' best play right there, Dave. Have that. Oftentimes, they'll get the center switching out Zubac onto LeBron, and he can go downhill on that guy. And that's what they run as well, and he couldn't get over, and nobody helped him.
Reddish way off from 3. 1 for 4, and 2 for 11 on the season. Westbrook rejected by James. And then he shakes his head.
2016 here, but this is figured out, balance it out. The hard part is he's their best player right now. And if you want to win the game, he's got to play.
Here's James for 3. Hits it. LeBron with his 3rd 3-pointer. Position, but is a ball handler that you have on the floor, so LeBron has to do more of that.
Well, if he's doing this, which he's doing it tonight.
An 18-point. LeBron James back out there. LeBron got 5.5 minutes of rest in that 3rd quarter. Working on Tucker. A pair of 38-year-olds going at it. And James wins, beating the shot clock buzzer.
Good defense, good offense. I mean, that's
Rim. Pull up 3, Paul George. Not that time. Zubac's tip right at the rim. Couldn't get it to fall. And eventually James takes it away. Throws it down court to Hayes for the fall.
Fighting for the rebound here, LeBron, one of the best passers, as we've talked about, and it's too easy for Hayes.
Easily, and D'Angelo Russell. Here's James. Bank shot, good for LeBron. He's got 25 now on just 13 shots.
Hey, going to your left, off the right hand, off the glass, tough angle, but his efficiency tonight has been the best thing. 9 at the Clippers and give him another option there.
Powell, I don't know if that was a push shot or an alley-oop attempt, but it's a turnover. Russell in transition with the layup. Lakers by 3.
I
did to play on Monday when the Clippers hit the road to play the Knicks, and Ty Lue told us Harden will start. Not really a surprise when he starts playing. James for mid-range. That's 27 for LeBron and a timeout.
Just got to find a way to get some easier shots here and get the ball to Kawhi. It's gonna be regular. And this is why I think they were so invested in making that deal happen. They just can't go ISO all the time in close games.
Led the NBA in assists last year. LeBron James with another mid-range basket.
Yeah, he's comfortable part about it.
LeBron, now on the switch, has Zubac on him. He'll pull it back out. Shot clock at 5. James, step back 3. You bet! LeBron James, he's running down the court saying that he's a bad.
I hear the same thing. He knows he can get whatever he wants here. He just relaxed, pulls back. Zubac tries to contest it, but just that's that pick and roll that gets.
There's 2.5 to play. Westbrook slips, lost his footing, lost the ball, a turnover. James, gorgeous pass ahead to Davis for the slam. That puts the Lakers up by 9, their largest lead of the night.
What's going on right now, but turnover, Westbrook looked like he just kind of slipped. And LeBron, easy pass, AD.
Kind of post, now gets out of there so Leonard can drive the lane. And he just turned it over, lost the ball. Numbers for the Lakers. Reeves, alley-oop, oh, James with the throw. In 2 months, he'll be 39.
Head's still quite up there, right? You can see how high. It's not just barely making it there. It's not just barely.
Tip-off presented by Pizza Hut. And on the first entry pass, Wembanyama rejects Devin Booker into the corner. Spots the open Okogie.
Yeah. But again, look at Victor running that right wing.
And Wembanyama right on the floor and hits Tater to the other end, and a timeout for the Suns. The Spurs have the first 9 in this one tonight.
And we're going to have our Methodist Healthcare assist right off the bat. This is what I love about Jeremy in this situation.
Spurs are able to play at their pace early against the Suns, and Victor inside, able to get the roll with the left hand.
Are we calling this a layup? I mean, he was open earlier, but it's still, he gets
like
the 2 points.
Roll. sizing up KD inside, slapped away from him. Charles Bassey knocks it over to Victor. Victor lays it up and in. Cell started this game with the first five for San Antonio. Wembanyama spots Trey Jones, open three, got it.
And that is your HEB inside the game.
That's the highest on the screen you've drawn on the telestrator in your career.
Yeah, right out of the timeout, the pass over the top, and you can't throw it too high.
Shooting 46%, 43% from downtown. Look at this mismatch. Victor, and gets the kind bounce.
Throw it over the top. That's what I'm talking about.
There is a whole tap pass. Sohan under the defense lays it up and in.
Yeah, I mean, even if you advance it to him, he's going to do something great with it.
Durant knocked away from him. He tried to sidestep Wembanyama. Trey Jones pushing back to Victor. Look out, lift off, and detonation for Wembanyama.
Here he is, right on cue. He's not going to force anything. Sees a big man trailing the break. And no one's going to get to that one. And there you go, pick your poison. You can't allow Devin Booker wide open three. And Malachi tries to get back to Grayson Allen.
Victor Wembanyama, nothing but the bottom on that three-pointer out top. And that's 17 first half points for Victor Wembanyama, a new high in any half.
Yeah.
A slow start with some foul trouble. Final 10 seconds. Wembanyama step into a three. Victor Wembanyama ending the half in style.
Uh-oh.
And Chetty Osman unable to add three more.
Then he comes back again. And you don't get on the way up, you have no shot. Victor with a big-time three.
Sit up the floor himself. It's a switch with Grayson Allen.
I'll throw it up to him.
Malachi back to Victor for two more.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Our guys are starting to adjust to him. So ridiculous. Throw the ball up there where no one can get to it. Here's the first one right over the top. Beautiful read there. I'll take the trade out.
And inside again, Victor just towering over the defense.
So what can you do as a defender? I ran him and then drove over the top of Eric Gordon. He's going to get it easy. Booker at the basket. Make somebody else make a play. Make him make an extra pass.
How about that spin move by Victor? And underneath Drew Eubanks lays it up and in.
Oh, Victor Wembanyama catches it. Beautiful spin move right off the bat. There he is, throwing up top over him again. Oh, there he is.
There it is, up top. Victor throws it down with a right hand. My goodness.
Even the fans here in Phoenix, they're smiling and laughing. That reverse layup, and he just threw it up there. He's going to do something with it.
And Eubanks inside, met there by Wemby, ducks it away.
Well, we've seen guys try to challenge Victor at the rim. Again, that's going to throw off a lot of offensive players.
Collins calling for the ball. Spin move inside on the baseline. Back to Wemby, upstairs. Victor throws it down. Timeout, Suns.
Any kind of shot. Drops it back off to Victor, who finishes over the top of Eubanks again. And that's a foul. That should have been an and one.
That's five unanswered by the Spurs. Since the Suns tied the game at 116 on the Can of HD op 3. What a response, though. Wembanyama met out top by Eubanks. Victor, pull up three. Got it! Victor Wembanyama hits the strings. Do that, 41 for David Robinson, who also had 39 and 38 in his rookie year.
With a minute 41, milk this thing all the way down. You should not be in a hurry.
Victor pulls up at the elbow, and Victor Wembanyama, 38 points with 10 rebounds tonight.
Shoulder fake, the inside out, to create all kinds of space to get that three.
Is it Dame time? Middleton looking to work Grimes. Middleton gets blocked from behind, wanted a foul. Brunson off to Grimes. Randall, 3 of 16. Randle trying to take Lopez, spins inside and finishes. That's what you were looking for, Richard.
Yes, look, I understand you're going against great defenders and you're going against bigs, but instead of settling and shooting threes, go at their body, try and get some free throws. That was a great drive and patient attempt by Julius Randle.
Just his third field goal attempt of the second half. Here's Lillard with the pick and roll that time with Giannis. Lillard dips inside and lays it in. Beautiful footwork from Damian Lillard. 101-97, Milwaukee in front. Lillard with 22, Giannis with 22. Randle into the lane again and gets fouled. Well, the in-season tournament ends in Vegas December 9th towards the regular season, and we have a tight one here. Randle now starting to get involved. Hits one of two from the line. By the way, Richard, you wondered when was the last time Giannis was fouled on a three-point attempt?
Yeah.
February 8th of 2022.
Okay.
By Anthony Davis.
Wow, that tracks.
Thank you, Matt Williams. Outstanding researcher. As Giannis travels and Milwaukee turns it over, the Knicks with an opportunity to cut it to one or tie here. 2:27 to go in the fourth. Milwaukee led by 14 in the third. They have maintained a modest lead, thwarting every Knicks push. Brunson, the crossover into the paint, got blocked from behind by Lillard. Good recovery from Damian Lillard. Just 12 field goal attempts tonight for Lillard. Can't lay that one in. Wanted a whistle. Did not get it. Robinson that has it poked away by Dame. And it's out of bounds off of Lillard. And immediately Milwaukee looking to challenge it. And
see, I
have to review.
Hold on.
Dame Lillard's right hand is the last to touch the ball prior to going out of bounds. The challenge by Milwaukee is unsuccessful. It'll be New York ball at the dead ball spot. New York loses their timeout and their challenge.
I want to see Dame set a step up, allow Giannis to get downhill, then Giannis has that outlet back to him versus Giannis setting the step up and then being at the three-point line while Dame is going downhill.
Each with 22 points, modest field goal attempts for each. Meanwhile, the Knicks down three with the ball. Brunson has scored 40. Here's Randle into the paint. Randle fading and hitting. Julius Randle has come alive down the stretch. It's a one-point game. Knicks have not led since it was 29-27 early in the second. Off to Middleton, who's up to 19 minutes. Lillard, five to shoot, stagnant possession. It last hits Lopez, and it's Knicks basketball.
It looks like there's some early confusion there from Giannis and Dame on the pick and roll, and then when he finally does come off, Giannis doesn't roll.
Here's Brunson with the Knicks down one. Randle lost the handle. Off to Brunson. His three. You bet! Jalen Brunson with 43. And the Knicks in front by two.
Player.
See what Milwaukee cooks up here. Down two now to the Knicks. Lillard turns, takes, and hits! Back in front by one. Under a minute to go. Brunson spins, leans, left it short. Middleton the rebound. Plenty of time for New York to play straight up defense. Middleton probing, dishing. Lillard lays it in. Puts the foul. It's game time. Big one here. He got it. Two-possession Milwaukee lead. A 6-0 Lillard run after Brunson put the Knicks in front. Randle trying to shake Giannis. Randle couldn't insist it in. And it's out of bounds. It will stay here with New York. So it does not matter who that hit last. Call on the floor is New York ball, and so it remains with the Knicks. Randle trying to create space. Working Giannis. Randle gets denied. Another rejection from Lopez. And a loose ball foul on New York. Lopez short on the free throw. Milwaukee just 17 of 25 from the line tonight. Lopez hits the second, and Tom Thibodeau will take his final timeout. Inbound to Hart. Well, there you go, Richard. Nailed it. Brunson pedals it into the paint. Taking a lot of time. Gets fouled by Lopez. And Milwaukee had a foul to give. So side out of bounds. Randall trying to get it back to Brunson. Brunson dashes in, lays it home. He has 45. Lillard trapped and fouled. Grimes and Brunson didn't think there was enough for there to be a whistle, but now Damian Lillard will go to the line.
A foul call there if you're the Knicks.
Lillard, an incredible free throw shooter, hits the first, 11 of 11 from the line tonight. Lillard has been big down the stretch. 30-point night for Dame. Brunson gets it up, can't hit, and Milwaukee holds off the Knicks. 110-105 in the first ever in-season tournament game.
That was from the dark web. A great crew led by Mark and Russ and Tamara. Get the chance to see this inaugural game of the in-season tournament with a Caruso break. To tie the game at 93.
It's his first points tonight. And you see, shoots with confidence, does not hesitate. Last year, he would look to pass that.
Here's Mikal Bridges, picked up by Vucevic with help from White. Dennis Smith steps in, got one off the three-point line. Loose ball, White punched it. Caruso's on the deck, and a jump ball, I believe. It is. Both of those guys now gone. Luka's running with Kyrie. Off the jump ball, Bridges misfires. Here's Craig and the Bulls with a chance for the lead at the halfway point of the fourth quarter. Ball in Levine's hands. Using Vucevic, but it's punched by Smith. Smart play defensively.
Well, they watched a lot of tape on that. Yep. That two-man game, they never report right back to.
And Bridges hits a 16th Nets three.
Yeah, they played that little dive cut very, very well.
White got bumped by Royce O'Neal. That'll be the fourth on O'Neal. Three-point shot has been a difference in this game. It kept the Bulls going in the first half, and it's helped the Nets take leads in the second. Levine. Step back over. Finney Smith got it to go. Zach Levine's got 21. DeRozan's got 22. Third time this year they both hit 20 in a game. Bridges. Caruso's there.
Good chance.
Four on the shot clock. Bridges swings it. Thomas launches it. No.
Oh, man, you got to get that rebound.
Simmons got it. O'Neal in and out. And Levine clears. Ooh. The Bulls get a break. 5 minutes left. 1 point lead for Brooklyn.
And they're in the penalty.
This time they slip to Vucevic. Get up. Left it short.
Save that challenge.
Yep. Yeah, good point. You don't have to use the timeout or a challenge here. Levine over Bridges. Tough shot. Won't go. 4:40 left. Vinny Smith. He's missed four in a row now from outside.
Let's see if they can get something good here now.
Vucevic posting up. Caruso had it stripped. Here comes Kobe White. Spinning. Shooting. Ball refusing to go down. Here's Simmons. Finney Smith finally breaks out of the slump. He hits the three. A back-and-forth sequence, and the Nets have a four-point lead. In the case Wednesday and trying to get back to it tonight.
Well, and this is these close-knit games where they're here for you to take. You've got to execute. Every possession is important down the stretch.
DeRozan. Into the paint. The kick to Caruso. They get it to Vucevic in the post.
I would ride him
Nice Kentucky Derby.
Because he's been on such a tear, teams are starting to double-team him now.
What did we talk about the other night? Constricting and expanding defenses. Finney-Smith, tough move, and he scores it. He's had a big night tonight.
And that's a tough matchup for Boosh, especially coming back out, closing out.
And especially now as we get later into the game. And the fatigue could set in. DeRozan steps up for a long two.
Hey, you need a stop here now if you're the Bulls.
Caruso barking out the orders at the top. So Vucevic is going to pick up Simmons to start. And Caruso will get tapped with a bump. That's only the first foul on the Bulls in the quarter.
That's where at the end of the game now, you just want to play solid defense. You know, stay on your guy. Help if you have to help. Know where the help is. I'd keep Vooch right on Ben Simmons. He's not going to be a threat out there shooting a jumper. But putting it on the floor is where he's dangerous.
Yeah, it's probably as close to an ideal matchup as Vooch can get in this lineup against Brooklyn. Thomas against White. Good contest, good shot.
Okay, good defense, better offense.
For the first second-half points for Cam Thomas tonight. Levine, stop and go. Finds Vooch. Open for three. Bang, bang, bang. It's a one-point game with 2.5 to play.
First three-point shot of the night.
Yeah, hadn't taken one until there, and it was a good one. Thomas. O'Neal. Back to Thomas. And Levine gambled that time, and he knew it.
Gotta stay solid to the principles of defense. No gambling. This team shoots way too good from the three-point line. 41%.
Made 18 of them tonight. Trying to get it to Vucevic. Good job by O'Neal. So White takes it out.
That's a good job by Vooch. Shielding off his man and opening up that driving lane. Because O'Neal was sealed. Just took him right out of the baseline to give Kobe White that drive. That's a moving screen.
Moving screen on Ben Simmons. Yes. Even the first week plus, they've been pretty consistent calling it. 100 seconds to play in a two-point game. DeRozan. Over Thomas. And Vucevic to tap. And into the hands of O'Neal. And here comes Brooklyn.
Gotta get a stop here for the Bulls.
Dean trying to stick with Bridges.
Oh, wow.
Bridges to the cup.
Can't quit on a play. You gotta stay deep. Stay solid defensive. The baseline is his friend. If he stands baseline, that's a turnover.
And use it as a second defender,
yes.
Right? Use it as help.
Yeah, he had him right there where he wanted him. Let him go baseline.
Levine. Zach Levine. Off the glass.
Nice ball move. Gotta get a stop here now.
60 seconds left. Two-point game.
Trying to get it to Bridges.
They're trying to get Caruso off of him. Bridges drives. Bridges shut off. Throws it to Thomas. Late in the clock. He's got to go. A desperation three. Good possession by Caruso. Multiple times this year for the Bulls.
Well, now they got this. They switch now. They were switching with Cam Thomas defensively.
Levine. Going to work against Bridges to tie the game. And Bridges taps it. White's got it. DeRozan. The clock is off. And a whistle. It's been a low turnover game on both sides. Here's Levine. Zach Levine on the drive to tie the game. No whistle, no foul. And the clock never reset either. Otherwise, you have to foul and send the Nets to the line. Inbound to Bridges, and he will go to the stripe.
Shot the ball, 96-88.
Next one is the big one.
Understanding the situation of what we're trying to get there in the half-court game.
Missed it. Billy Donovan will use a timeout. To force the three.
He can play the long game.
Now the clock's starting to wind. Now they're going to need a three.
Here comes Levine to get it. Zach Levine got fouled.
Make and then miss spot. Let's see. We get the make.
They tip it out.
Back rim, it's missed. Loose ball to Levine. Fires the tire. And that'll do it.
Warriors switched everything. It really bothered the Thunder. Klay Thompson to tie the game. Got it! No hesitation. And why would you hesitate when you're Klay Thompson?
GP2's coming to meet Giddey at half court. They were letting ball handlers for OKC get downhill too easily.
Yeah, Warriors tied the game.
And that running start. Steph trying to deny Giddey. Shot clock at 5. Cason Wallace to the rim. Draymond sends him away. Chance to take the lead. Klay with Holmgren. A little smart for a young guy. Didn't let him pull. Klay Thompson. Klay driving. The hook pass. GP2. And missed off iron. Steph kept it alive, but Dort's got it.
None of the screens are working on this end because the Warriors are switching everything pretty well. It's just on-ball defense after any switch.
Jalen Williams, shot clock at 7. Here's that running start again. Klay moved his feet nicely.
Oh, no, no, no. He baited him into that call because Jalen Williams grabbed his face. That was a tough one.
And the big rebounder in the sky agrees.
What would Rasheed Wallace say?
Bottom line. What Steve was saying is, and the initial contact, he blew a whistle fine. You waited, and then Williams touched his face, then you blew the whistle?
That's what made it so irritating.
So that gives the Thunder the one-point lead. Chris Paul finding Steph for 3. No, there's a foul on Curry.
That's a foul on Dort.
Yeah.
The flare screen. Warriors have run this play.
He fouled trying to get through Draymond's screen. Steph with Dort all over him. Shot clock at 3. Draymond at 2. Turns and fires it off iron. Here comes Giddey. Full head of steam. And GP2 hustling back to knock it out of bounds.
That's just effort. He's sprinting to make sure he gets back. Now you got to make sure you don't give up something easy. No mistakes. Switch everything.
Cason Wallace holding up top. They wanted Giddey on Chris Paul. Now they switch. Giddey's got Steph. GP2 got a hand on it. Shot clock at 7. Giddey and Holmgren, little two-man game. Giddey spinning.
Jump ball.
You got the jump ball early.
Yeah, I think GP2 can win this jump ball.
There's no reset of the shot clock, too, so 1.3 to shoot.
As GP2 is always getting his hands on these basketballs, just causing havoc. Just got it from behind.
You got to make sure Giddey at 6'8 doesn't tap it to Holmgren.
Well, you got to make sure you box him out. This is where you get physical with Holmgren.
And there you Payton go. Wins the tap. You don't need a 3 yet.
They got to... Yeah, keep playing.
Well, the 24-second buzzer buzzed.
Yeah, they got to reset that. There's a lot going on in this game.
There's a lot going on.
I understand it.
So 21 to shoot.
All right, OKC, let's get loud.
Needless to say, this is a super important possession.
Curry splits the double team. Curry down the lane. Curry puts it up and in.
Yeah, that is exactly what the doctor ordered, a quick one.
Jalen Williams on GP2. Trying to get that head of momentum. Jalen Williams, he kicked it. He bounced it. Klay's got a steal. Klay is fouled.
Klay's falling down. He's in pain, though. He's good. That's big.
So now you're going to get Klay Thompson free throws and a chance to take the lead.
The Warriors love that. Great defensive possession. It just kind of lost it as GP2 is guarding, but that happens when GP2 is around a lot. Originally, Clay was wincing in pain. He wants a review because...
Now, well, no. What he wants is this a transition tank foul?
Yeah.
They're asking if, okay, did he trip Clay to stop a fast break? And there was no thunder back.
And Jalen's got six fouls, so he's out of the game.
He is. Jalen Williams is fouled out.
Yeah, Warriors had momentum going the other way.
Well, they're freezing Klay Thompson at the foul line. We've got a lot of delay here.
Klay's just got a little smirk on his face. Yeah, the Warriors win this game. Unbelievable.
Neither team is led by double figures, though. Thunder were up 7. Warriors were up 9. We had 20 lead changes, 12 ties. Incredible.
Yeah, I think the defender there might have made a play on the ball, and that's probably enough.
And Clay bottoms that free throw.
Tie game.
Now, OKC can get aggressive. The clock could be two for one for them.
They can, but if I was them, I'm not going to rush anything. Like, if the 2-for-1 is there and it's a great shot, take it. But if you don't have that, you need to score to take the lead.
Clay hits them both, and OKC takes time. Holmgren holding. Trying to drive on Draymond. Chet Holmgren runs over Draymond. It's a blocking foul.
That's rough. That's, I mean, do you just challenge it?
And Chet Holmgren to the foul line to shoot two. 80% free thrower coming in. He's 6 of 6 tonight.
Where's it going to have a chance either way?
Both teams have a timeout. And Holmgren ties the game. His first 20-point night, he's got 22 for the evening, making 23 with the made free throw.
Now Chris Paul's coming back in. Steph's back in there.
So Steph and Chris Paul, this was the offensive substitution. And he drops them both in. 30 ticks left. Draymond, the naked handoff, lob, GP2 laid it in!
Everybody focused on Steph.
OKC takes time!
Your nose out in front,
and if you do get a miss, can you grab a rebound?
Rebound it, and not foul.
Giddy on GP2, backdoor cut, Lou Dort is fouled.
You need to be perfect closing games out, especially one like this.
Ooh. And Lou Dort misses. Now, I think make or miss, Steve's taking a timeout because you got to get Steph or Chris Paul unless you put him in right now.
Yeah, you're putting him in right now. You're good. Now you just got to box out.
Now you don't need a timeout necessarily. Against Sacramento, they didn't take a timeout.
Yeah. You got time to run it up, get some momentum.
OKC's out of timeouts.
Yeah, sometimes coaches like that, especially when you got a guy like Steph.
So Dort needs this one to tie the game. Draymond and Looney are in for rebounding. And he made it. So now Steve will use a timeout. And they got it to Curry. He sizes up Dort. He's directing traffic down to 8. Steph gets moving at 5. Dort, a great defender at 3. Curry sidestep. Curry drive. Curry flip. Curry good! With 2 tenths again!
Oh, they're saying they touched the basket. Someone touched the basket. They got to review it, though.
They're going to review it and see if it's basket interference.
After review, the basket interference call on the court has been overturned to a successful basket. successful.
Steph Curry with 2:10 left, and the game is not over.
It's a Hail Mary. So Giddy, the Hail Mary, the tip. No! And the Warriors with the win! They've won 5 in a row!
As Steph hit the night-night.
Starting off the season 0-5. Coming off a spanking at the hands of Utah on Wednesday night. Brogdon to three, got it. Brogdon off the screen, picked up by Jackson on the switch, over to Grant. Goes in Roddy, step back from the elbow, counted and a foul! Yes, sir! The slip come out on top, coming to it is Bane. Bounces low to Roddy, intercepted by Brogdon. Picks up the loose ball, advances to Grant. In he comes to Brogdon, laying up and in. 3-point lead for Memphis. Williams will screen. He'll slip. Go to the rack. Two-hand damage for Williams.
That should be a tech.
He hung on the rim.
It's because he pulled up. Plus, quality is paramount for them.
Kamara showing length. Now they switch. Trying to draw the foul is Smart. Outside Payne tees up a three. No. 8 in the rebound. Here comes Sharp out of backcourt. He'll rush it up into the paint, out to Grant, in the air, three around and out, batted away and out of bounds. Blazer basket. Sharp, one-on-one to Roddy, drives into the lane, ball jostled away, last touch by Memphis, a whistle.
Wow.
With 7 seconds remaining. Boy, a look of supreme confidence. And Sharp has tied the ball game. This is Smart. Juggled out to Kennard. Blocked by Sharp. Closing ground. Extra basketball in Portland as Sharp got to it in time. Memphis had a 10-point lead with 3:15 remaining in this game. Blazers win the tip. Grant handling, checked by Tillman. Working the edge to the baseline. Leans, double-teamed, rockets a pass over there. Smart intercepts, it's loose. He's able to save it, and into the hands of Jackson. Marcus Smart making the play. 6 steals on the night for Memphis. He comes off the screen. Kamara right with him. Terminates the dribble, needs help. Kennard will come to get it. Stumbles away from Sharp, leans in, pops, yeah. No, too strong. Rebound grab.
Yeah. He had flashbacks.
He did.
He really, it was only a couple minutes ago. He remembers vividly what took place.
Brogdon locked in on Grant. The entry pass deflected out of bounds. Bane diving for it. Kamara getting valuable experience. 27 yes. minutes here tonight and yes. playing in crunch time and now into the overtime.
Whether he's making his shot or not, he's still growing in this moment.
Yeah, he's still 6'8 with long arms.
Yeah.
They'll bring it in bounds to Brogdon. Checked by Bane, goes to the body, brings it back outside. Strong left-hand dribble, forced to veer up on top. Regathers three, leans in one. He walked with the basketball.
That's good defense from Bane. Hussein, he's locking Malcolm up. We'll see if he'll keep that same energy throughout this remaining 4 minutes. Because Malcolm will continue to go at him when the opportunity presents itself. It's a good matchup between those two.
Jackson backing down on 8. Flat shot rolling up. Kamara ties up Tillman, able to pry it free with those huge mitts. And it comes free to Sharp. Sharp surveys the scene off the screen. A burst on Bane to the baseline. He's trapped down there. There's a whistle. And they say he stepped out of bounds.
Well, on a night when Shaden's not shooting the ball well, his whole team isn't. He made 2 huge free throws, which is part of that superstar growth process. Being the one to go to the line and take those big free throws. And then got the block. So he's going to stay locked in no matter what happens. That turnover is not going to force him to drop his head.
Smart Smart going lefty. Ball stripped as he goes up. Jackson lost it. And here comes Sharp the other way.
Oh, he got D.A. with the guard on him.
Looking in deep. Bean trying to uproot Ayton. Cross-court pass, Sharp along the edge. 1-on-1 on Tillman with a strong left hand. Switches to the right. Went up. Slithers down. Rebound Ayton. Plays on and lays it home. And the Blazers lead it by two with 2:57 to go in overtime. Jeremy Grant nearly had a pick. Bain with it. They used up too much time.
Foul. Trying to set a screen. Tillman. Shaden takes two Grizzlies with him. Now DA's got a one-on-one offensive rebounding situation with Kennard. He's going to win that.
2:38 remaining in overtime, and the Blazers leading by two. Sharp again into the lane. Elevates and finger rolled it up and in over the retreating Jackson. Oh, a brilliant play by Sharp. 17 on the night. Blazers by four. Jackson and Smart load up up top, trying to spring Bain. He is met by Brogdon into the lane. Off balance, no follow there by Jackson up and in. Rolling up on 2 minutes left. Blazers in overtime, leading by two. Sharp again.
They want the screen with Tumani. They're not getting it. Shea draws a foul anyway. Now, see, so Coach Billups, he's calling Tumani over. He's trying to tell him how he wants him to set that screen. Because right now, they want the ball in this man's hand, making moves like that.
Terrific extension.
Yeah.
To go up that's, over Jackson like that.
That's what we were talking about in that third quarter, I believe it was. When he goes with that right arm, he just extends over everybody else.
Grant in deep, gives to Ayton, squares up, punts it up from about 15 feet out, rimming into the hands of Jackson. 2-point lead, Blazers, 1:40 to go in the overtime. Bain to midcourt. Being hounded by Grant, who is clipped on the screen by Jackson. He'll pop out, get the pass. Ayton recovers, then Jackson on the deck to tie the game.
He's made some 3-point shots, Kev, in this game. So he is being respected as a shooter after 4-7 from the three-point line.
Jackson with 27. Again, it's Sharp outside for three. Yes, sir! Shaden Sharp giving the Blazers a lead of three. 1:16 left in the overtime. And the young man has 20 on the night. He had 29 against Detroit a few nights ago in the win. 26 in the second half and was brilliant at crunch time. Bain. Overrunning is Grant. Bain will drive it into the lane. Gets into Kamara. And a blocking foul on Tumani Kamara.
Now, if there's any doubt on this play, the officials can look at this. It's a trigger. Restricted area trigger. Well, you can't go under on Shea. You can't lose sight of him. You can't give him space.
Well,
he's ready for the big moments. Now, hey. Been nice to have the officials check out that replay on that. It's not a coach's challenge, but it's a restricted area trigger when you're in the last two. And it's if there's doubt that Tumani is in the restricted area there, he's clearly out. So the officials feeling like there's no need to go and review it. But if they review it, they can not only see is he in the restricted area, they can see was he legal? Was he set? Before the upward shooting motion started. And it looks like that might have been a block regardless.
Bain goes to work, hits the two free throws. Blazers will lead to 1:57 seconds remaining. And Sharp will bring it across. Ayton will screen.
And now he's getting a superstar treatment. Double team. Now his teammates can play with numbers. Memphis gets back though.
Brogdon outside to Grant. Turns, squares, hits the three-point shot, 39 seconds remaining. Grant drills a three. The Blazers lead by four. Memphis called.
I like Miles going through the process of making the decision of what needed to be done.
And he'll shoot the 17-footer and hit it.
If you will, for
in first quarters.
Mathurin. Acrobatic layup.
19 points here early in the season. Here's a three by Turner. It's good. Miles hit four of them last night. Pacers out-rebounded the Cavaliers last night, 40-35.
Made a mistake.
What a pass and what a basket.
Good cut as well. This is part of the adrenaline, the juice, the entire process that I was talking about after you played such a big game. It's hard to keep that going.
Tyrese Haliburton with the basket.
And then put yourself in a position to make a play.
Offensive rebound.
Drive it and find somebody.
Haliburton creates.
He's on the rim that time. And he's going to have to be the one that does create. And Utah made a decision. That's how the Pacers got Paul George. Because Utah took, they took Haliburton.
Heading to the second half. Here's a step back three. Haliburton got it.
That's his thing over there. If he starts dancing you on that right side, easy.
Of the second quarter.
Yeah, there you go. Easy. Now get it back to him. And now you play. And whatever comes out of it, you take.
Here's a three by Haliburton. He knew it.
Well, he also knows.
Brown back the other way. Pacers moved it up the floor quickly. Here's Haliburton. Three. Top of the key. Tyrese. He's made three since the clock was at 1 minute.
The Pacers have to get some offense started. Really good read by Bruce Brown. He's got Rozier. He knows Rozier cannot block.
Pacers scored a season low 46 first half points. Haliburton again. Boy, he's dialed in.
He's going to have to recognize that. Fortunately, extra pass. That's partially blocked. Energy.
Running, Mathurin inside, steps out to Haliburton. Here's another three. Got it! Tyrese Haliburton! Tyrese Haliburton with 27 points.
Yeah. Could have been very well in the top.
Turner for three. 7 of 7 from three-point range.
Listen, they got ball handlers that can drive. And one.
And they'll count it.
Yeah, they got it. They have to pick it up late. Now watch. He picks it up. If he picks it up early, there's no doubt. He's got it.
Haliburton again out of the turn.
There we go. That's right. Step into it.
Third of the night for Miles Turner. Made four of them last night.
They got Brandon Miller on him. He's a little bit longer. See, when he gets back to him, it's a whole different thing.
Long three, Haliburton again.
Ooh, right over. My energy is shifted. See, Miles does a really good thing. He moves it. Neesmith gets back. Look, he's out on the G at Gainbridge.
27% from three. Jalen Smith right at the rim.
This is Haliburton who's driving the offense.
They've outscored Charlotte here in the third.
Great pass. Great pass. Let me tell you what was happening. They had rotated out to the right.
From three-point range in the third quarter.
Watch this. Now, they think they're coming to right there. They were thinking it's coming to Jalen.
Here's Haliburton again.
You're talking about feeling it. He is feeling it. I mean, just. Oops. Oops. And the teardrop.
38 for Haliburton, 25 in the third quarter.
Haliburton, he told him to slip. He wanted to get this through. He told him to slip. And that's why he's confident in taking a shot, because if your guard tells you to slip.
Haliburton got it. He's got 40.
He has a way of getting, even coming out of something panicked.
Allowing nearly 60 points in the paint, so that's been the problem. Here's Neesmith. His three in the corner, good.
And I mean, he had Williams running at him. Yeah, you can get it. You can see you have to get it back to Halliburton to get into something.
Here's a long three.
Deep three!
He got it. He's got
deep three. You can see that leaving his hand. That is a deep three. Look, he's out here. A step inside the blue on the logo and just let it fly.
Hopes to have a big who can run the floor like that. Young legs, Doc Rivers.
Jokic gets inside and the Nuggets get on the board. Nikola Jokic coming off that spectacular season last year.
Grant Williams has been one of the best three-point shooters through the first week plus of the regular season.
Jamal Murray can't connect. Jokic right there with the tip.
And also when Jason Kidd gets tossed for by a referee.
Jokic knocks down the three. 31 points already with still 3.5 to go. Hardaway turns it over. Jokic, Caldwell Pope quickly gets inside. The offense erupting. He is a chatterbox.
I thought that's what you were saying about the right decision.
Meanwhile, Jokic tips it in. He is one of the most delightful players in the NBA to talk to.
Jokic has Hardaway on him. That should be easy, and it is.
They really do. They have to get along on the floor.
Okay, you just shocked me, Tom.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say something basketball-wise.
No, it's just once you have the want to this year, they're not in each other's way.
Doncic misses that three. Porter gets the nice feed from Jokic. Bank shot is good. Porter, 11 points.
I remember they said that about a LeBron James guy.
Yeah, they did.
You know, and it's so true. But I think when you look at his body, you did have some worries as well.
Jokic flips it up and in. Jokic catches it, puts up the three. Count it at the buzzer. That's the way to answer. Nikola Jokic. As the first half comes to an end.
To this game, third highest scoring team in the NBA. Again, only just four games, but they were a potent offense last year. They'll be a potent offense this year. It's this side of the floor that has to get better for them to...
Michael Porter catches, fires, can't hit. Gordon's tip misses, ball knocked loose, picked up by Porter again. More offensive boards. And Jokic sees a path, stops, and just flips it up and in.
You never get tired of that.
Jokic double team, finds Gordon. Gordon up and under, and he taps it in.
They will let you back in if you hang, if you just hang in there.
Jokic flips it up and in. He's now 11 of 12 from the field. A little double clutch. Jokic tips it away, leads the break, pushing up the floor, finds the open man, the trailer.
They've had the most threes made by a team in the first four games of the season ever. They've got 14 tonight. Gordon cuts inside. What a beautiful pass and another movement without the ball. Nuggets looking to bounce back after their first loss of the season. Jokic has Doncic on him. These two great players. Another gorgeous pass to Gordon.
Jokic is absolutely amazing. Obviously, you have to finish, but my goodness.
Technical foul call. Jamal Murray. Him and Irving, they've gone at it pretty good. Porter back to Murray. Jokic catches, falling away, puts it up, puts it in. That makes it a dozen.
That's ridiculous. Hits him with a little Sambor shuffle there, defenders. They're trying Grant Williams on it. Grant trying to be physical, but release point, I'm bigger than you. That Sambor shuffle, he goes off the one leg. His touch is ridiculous.
The late clock, you get it to him, yeah. You know.
And the Nuggets will slow it down. Jokic cuts to the basket, sidestep, and a foul.
He's better than me right now. that's one of the things.
He's had some great games. He knows that some nights it's going to be brutal.
And Jokic flips it up and in.
Draymond getting Holmgren out of the lane. He blocked 7 shots in a game earlier this year. That's the most open Steph will be on a three, and you know that is going in. Šarić dropping in the three. Šarić had hit 1 3.
That one off front iron. Steph tipping it to GP2.
Baited. Now he's at the rim because he just kept going. And GP2.
Dort back in. Curry back in. Klay Thompson three. Klay Thompson, he's got 10. Wiggins headed back the other way. Curry on the trail. And Giddey hustled up so he couldn't launch that three. And then no-look lob. And GP2 180s it. And the showmanship of Steph Curry. The no-look hook pass. And OKC takes time with the Dubs up six.
Yeah, that's not very good, actually, especially on the road. Jalen Williams. Look at the Warriors play the defense, though.
Curry headed the other way. Curry three. Got it.
Steph Curry is unreal. And coming down in transition, he's always live.
Steph Curry, a three in response, is good. And this time, Cason Wallace.
Man, you throw the NBA Cup out there to play for, everybody's knocking down threes and playing well.
Steph and Draymond have been doing it for a dozen years.
Getting in the right position. Look at the two defenders, including Jalen Williams, who was on Draymond, jumping to Steph, the pocket pass.
Wiggins, tough fadeaway. Tipped up and out, and Looney.
Oh, no.
Missed the dunk.
There you go.
Steph is there to follow it up. Šarić finding Klay, attacking and floating it up and out. Draymond back out to Šarić. Steph shot that from Enid, Oklahoma, and lasers in a three.
Defenders, offensive rebounds. This is what offensive rebounds will do for you, and I don't know what Dort is thinking going up.
Here comes Giddey with the step around, flip it up and out, and Curry back the other way, running with friends. Steph weaving, and he'll peel out and launch from the baseline. Perfect.
He just found some space.
The Dubs have been number one in the league in field goal percentage defense in the early part of the year. Curry again answers with a three.
He's got it locked on automatic. Anything going to the rim, all these flip shots, he's making them look easy.
Kuminga. There's Holmgren. He climbs the mountain to lay it in.
He's not afraid of the moment. Big time minutes for him.
That one deflected. Draymond, great hands. Put it in through the foul. Steph Curry splits the double team. Curry down the lane. Curry puts it up and in. Steph gets moving at five. Dort a great defender at three. Curry sidestep. Curry drive. Curry flip. Curry good. With 2 tenths again.
8-point game. Still time for the Clippers. Again, this is where James Harden helps. Not that there is an isolation play with James Harden, but obviously you got another distributor, another ball handler. Not seeing great ball moved by the Clippers here down the stretch. Westbrook takes a three. It's good, though, and that pulls the Clippers within five.
It's just they don't know it. That's fine. That's a great shot by Westbrook. They're still in the game. They just don't, they don't have the action to go to, right? They don't have that, where are we going in a close game? The Lakers, look, they know where they're going. They know what they're doing, and that's what I think Harden will bring them, some certainty as to where to go in the half court. Here's the AD LeBron pick and roll. I mean, that's what they tried to get. They got Tucker on LeBron.
James driving on Tucker, hangs, missed it, but James will go to the free throw line.
With LeBron, and we say his age, I don't care if he's 21 or 25. These numbers he's putting up are good.
36 minutes for LeBron James tonight. Missed the second free throw. Still time for the Clippers, down six, a minute to go. Paul George got five threes in the game. He's got Anthony Davis on him. He gets past him, and he's fouled by Davis. Count the basket, and a chance at a three-point play, which would pull the Clippers within three. Missing the free throw is Paul George. He had missed one free throw all season prior to that miss right there.
Probably the most important one, right? And he could have made it a one-possession game.
He was 26 of 27 prior to that miss. Lakers ball up four, shot clock at six. Russell, he's got 25 points on the night. Drives, floater, no good. Short, rebound George. Clippers ball down four, 9-second difference in the game in shot clocks. George, pull up three, buries it, and gets the Clippers within one. There's a tenth of a second difference. Now there's not. So either way, the Clippers have to foul. And they're going to foul D'Angelo Russell. Timeout as well. There's enough time, 18 and a half seconds. Russell gets the second one. Nope, Ty Lue's going to call it.
But they don't have to. They could pressure in the front court, foul. And the Lakers free throw shooters, LeBron's been 5 of 10 from the line. So there's some options here if you go quick two.
Here's George against Reddish. Puts up the three. No good off the back rim. Wow. And a foul, a late whistle, a foul on Reddish. Paul George will shoot three to tie the game. 33-year-old in his 14th season out of Fresno State from the LA area. Hits the first one. But George, Leonard, and James. Gets George to tie the game. Got it. All even at 117 apiece. The Lakers will not call a timeout. It'll be LeBron James bringing it up the floor. Kawhi Leonard waiting for him. 10 seconds to go. Now on the switch, Tucker on James. Jump pass to the corner, Wood. 2 seconds left. 1 second. Russell for the win. No. And we go to overtime. Paul George. 45 minutes played for Davis, 39 for LeBron James, 33 points for James, 27 points for Davis. Here's Reeves, hit a couple of big baskets in the third quarter, has struggled most of the night, but is fouled and count the basket. 3-point chance for Austin Reeves.
That's what he did all playoffs last year. Attacking the basket, getting fouled, getting contact. It's the AD, like I said, this is the, he was good at this. This isn't something he just learned. This is the pick and roll. He's going downhill, getting contact, knocking it down. But here's what's going on the other end too, Dave. With Zubac in the game, it lets Anthony Davis just sit in the paint. And so Kawhi's trying to get to the rim. Anybody else on the Clippers, Westbrook's trying to get to the rim. AD doesn't have to guard Zubac on the perimeter, so he's just packing the paint. That's why the Clippers had success going small. That's why Paul George fouling out. Where are the Clippers going to get offense now?
Five fouls now on Norman Powell. You got Westbrook bringing it up the floor. Out there with Zubac, Leonard, Powell, and Tucker. Christian Wood, along with Davis, James, Reddish, and Reeves. Shot clock inside 10 seconds. They double Leonard. Powell is open. Can't knock down the three. And James with his 10th rebound. Lakers ball leading by three. 3 minutes to play in overtime.
There it is. Look, they're setting it up. This is that pick and roll just to get Zubac back out on the run. Get that switch.
Kawhi Leonard's played almost 40 minutes tonight. James driving baseline, fires to Wood. Shot clock at two. Reeves has to let it fly. Does. Misses. James bats it out into the backcourt, and Reeves tracks it down. Shot clock at 10. James for three. Off the front iron. And rebounded by Leonard. Westbrook on the move, goes at Reeves, missed the shot, batted by Davis, and ends up in the hands of Tucker. Clippers down three. Here's Kawhi with Wood on him. Zubac's trying to post. Now gets out of there so Leonard can drive the lane, and he just turned it over and lost the ball. Numbers for the Lakers. Reeves, alley-oop, oh, James with the throwdown in transition. What a night for LeBron.
Facing. For the Clippers right now, they did get a good shot with Norman Powell a couple possessions ago, but where are they going to find offense here? Where are they going to get a good look?
Clippers down five, just outside 2 minutes to go. Leonard with Davis on him, gets into the paint, spinning, gives it up. Powell penetrates. 3 from Leonard, short. Rebound Tucker. Leonard again, this time for the corner, misses again. The tip, no. Out of bounds, going to stay with the Clippers. And with the last two threes short by Kawhi Leonard, again, you wonder about
and especially that one. Yeah, that one in the corner there. You figure that could be the legs because that's a shot he makes most of the time.
I mean, when is the last time he played 72 minutes in 24 hours? As we say that, he gets a big shot through contact, finishing, getting the basket, and he'll go to the line and try to make it a two-point game as Davis commits the foul.
You know what? Look, he's so good. He's so strong. And Anthony Davis is not easy. These shots, they're contesting the heck out of his shots, by the way. The ones he missed, that left wing three, they had two guys running at him the length of Anthony Davis. I think they might have missed the out-of-bounds call. We didn't get a replay of it, but
that out of bounds on that previous possession. There was some groaning. I didn't get a good look at it.
Leonard connects on the foul shot. He was just 2 for 5 from the line before that make. And the Clippers not going away again. They fought back to force overtime, and they're just down 2. Leonard, 35 points. Paul George is fouled out with 35 points. LeBron has 35 for the Lakers. Reeves double, shot clock at 8. Davis, 15-footer, can't get it. Clippers ball looking to tie or take the lead. Westbrook racing down the court. Gives it up, blocked by Wood from behind. And Reddish comes away with it. Westbrook doesn't need to foul. Not sure why he did that there. That's his 5th.
Good job setting up Zubac. He just couldn't finish.
But he commits the foul also, which is the 1st in the last 2 minutes. Reeves around the screen. Stops. Pops. Hits. Lakers up 4 with a minute to go.
And they're calling Zubac into that high screen and roll. And that's just giving the Lakers a pretty clean look when they want it.
Here's Leonard, step back 3, on the money! Kawhi Leonard gets the Clippers within a point. Leonard has 38 in 41 minutes.
Wow.
Reeves with Powell on his hip, and they're going to call a foul on Powell, and he's gone. That's his 6th foul, and Reeves will go to the line. So Reeves... it's the 1st one. 5 points in overtime for Austin Reeves. Been a struggle this year for Reeves, certainly based on how he played in the playoffs last year, but he's had a great 2nd half. Lakers by 3. Leonard hit a 3 a moment ago. This time he'll drive and give it up. Westbrook for 3. Miss it off the front rim. Rebound Tucker. Now Hyland to tie it. No good off the heel. Reeves with the rebound. Stripped by Leonard, but into the hands of James. Clippers have to foul, down 3, or they can let it play out. There's a 7-second difference in the clocks. Do you want to take it down this far?
I think now they committed to letting it play out.
Tucker trying to get around the screen. Now Reeves, 5 to shoot, to the corner. 3 from Reddish, no good. Oh, there's Wood with the backside slam to perhaps put this one away.
No timeouts, Clippers got to go. Got to get a 3 here. And then try to get a steal or a foul quick.
7 seconds left. Westbrook drives. Missed the layup. The putback. No. Lakers ball. And that'll do it. What a great game here in Los Angeles as the Lakers end the hex.
Heard JJ talk about it. You see the unique court that you will see across all 7 games tonight for the in-season tournament contest as Brunson starts with a bucket. Now, to your point, JJ, about the communication with Lillard and Adetokunbo as Brunson hits the jumper. After that loss to Toronto, Connaughton short on a 3. Rebound bounces around to Hart. Knicks off and running again. Brunson lays it in. And this has been a major issue for Milwaukee in the early season. A 6-point Milwaukee lead, 1st night of the in-season tournament. 4 games of group play, and then we move on to the knockout quarterfinals. Brunson wiggles and finishes through the body of Lopez.
And that's where he's so good, getting into the paint. And gets the swing pass out of the Julius Randle double team.
Giannis, the 1st bucket, double figures. Here's Brunson. He got it. On a much-needed 3 for New York, Jalen Brunson up to 16 points.
I think my adoration came from when I exited Milwaukee. I think that was the start of the process.
Here's Brunson going baseline and laying it in. Nice scoop from Jalen Brunson. Here's Brunson off the handoff. Brunson swooping through with the touch. Absolutely. Randle, again, sort of a stagnant possession. Brunson ends up with a clean look and knocks it down. Jalen Brunson has 25 points, 9 of 15 from the floor. Brunson and Lillard. Brunson wheeling into Hartenstein. Nifty delivery in a tight space.
And the Knicks wanted a flop there on Beauchamp. Did not get one. Brunson, the crossover, the lay, and the foul. A chance for three for Jalen Brunson as the Knicks again.
It out quickly, and this is just so tough to guard if you're Pat Connaughton. You know Jalen Brunson wants to get to that left hand.
Portis, strong take, couldn't finish. Brunson the rebound, an opportunity for New York. Brunson wiggling through the lane, and the uncanny touch. Jalen Brunson with a 30-point night. Three.
Jalen Brunson trying to keep the Knicks in it.
With his fourth three of the night, Milwaukee is 17 of 31. Here's Brunson, has the switch on Lopez. Separates, and hits. Jalen Brunson with 34. Third three for Adetokounmpo on three attempts. That's Brunson.
Now he's getting whatever he wants. He's getting to wherever he wants.
And then go set that little step up screen, and it's going to create something positive for you.
Wow. Brunson just blasts to the rim and snuck it in over Lopez. 38 for Jalen Brunson. 38 tonight.
Brunson's been outstanding, going right at Dame Lillard, getting the easy bucket over Brook Lopez, who's been blocking shots.
Here's Adetokounmpo, spinning, can't finish, rebound Hart, pushing for New York, Brunson into the paint, Euros, and banks it in. It's a 40-point night for Jalen Brunson. Randle lost the handle, off to Brunson, his three, you bet! Jalen Brunson with 43, and the Knicks in front by two.
So on back-to-back possessions, they go to Randle. He creates separation on the first possession, gets the easy.
Now 12 seconds remaining in the Knicks down five. Randle trying to get it back to Brunson. Brunson dashes in, lays it home. He has 45.
R.J. Barrett, but I also think without R.J. Barrett in the lineup tonight, this is a perfect opportunity for Julius Randle to get going.
Adetokounmpo off the dish from Lillard, and the easy finish. Giannis weaving his way, and the finesse.
But good to see him getting going early.
Limited to about 16 minutes as Adetokounmpo soars to the rim, and Milwaukee races out to a great start. Here is Lillard. Look at his shake. Grimes flips it in. Beautiful take from the seven-time All-Star.
And even though that's not a transition bucket, that's an open transition three. And so you got to get back. You got to match up. And that might seem like a common thing to be talking about, but they're just not doing a very good job of it as you see the little back cut for Connaughton.
Here's Lillard. Finding Portis on the roll for the finish.
And those opportunities are going to be there for the Bucks with the Knicks bigs playing up in the pick and roll coverage. Stein in this pick and roll all the way up in coverage. Portis behind. Brunson doesn't come over and tag Portis early. That's an easy bucket for Bobby Portis.
Remember, these games also count towards your regular season record. Lillard connects on a deep delivery.
Pickup point is a little bit different than other players.
Here's Lillard, catch, fire, and hit from three. Brunson was a player who did everything he could in the playoffs last year for the Knicks. Lillard a deep three, spot on. That ends a 10-0 Knicks run. Here's Giannis firing away. He got one. Found money.
Fantastic death stare.
A finish just behind you, too, so it's almost like it was towards you.
As Giannis carries the three, Milwaukee is shooting the lights out. Knicks have missed 12 straight threes. Giannis again. When Giannis is making them like this.
Three. Giannis now up to three made threes tonight.
which gritty play from Brunson that here they are down just four. Now quickly providing some offense as well. Quickly gives it up. Hardenstein gets the nine at the rim by Adetokounmpo.
Absolute stellar rim protection. Giannis here rotating over as the low man.
Just his third field goal attempt of the second half. Here's Lillard with the pick and roll that time with Giannis. Lillard dips inside and lays it in. Beautiful footwork from Damian Lillard.
This on the other side. Dame Lillard taking his time. Shifty. Little up fake. Doing what he had to do. Getting the little layup.
See what Milwaukee cooks up here. Down two now to the Knicks. Lillard turns, takes, and hits! Plenty of time for New York to play straight up defense. Middleton probing, dishing, Lillard lays it in! Puts the foul! It's Dame time!
Well, Chris Middleton finds himself in space, and Dame just trailing the play. Quentin Grimes not paying
attention. Ooh, I thought they might get a 5 second call. But he made it. But what he's been finding and what the coaches told Coach Carlisle at the end of the game, play Buddy. And he's earned the right to play.
But Hayward misses. And a basket on the rebound by Mark Williams.
Chris, they have been on the glass pretty steadily there.
Yeah, 39-32 out rebounding the Pacers, and Williams has 22.
And they've got 72 points in the paint.
Mark Williams with a career high matching 22. And it could be a new career high with his free throw where he is perfect tonight.
I wasn't looking for the career high there, but I mean, I know you're sharing the information. I wasn't looking for that.
Pacers down five.
They're coming at him big.
Bruce Brown for three.
Well, they came at Halliburton with 2 6'9" guys, Washington and Miller.
5 point Charlotte lead. Pacers beat the Hornets here a year ago in the only game played in Indianapolis.
Well, he needs help.
Turner the rebound. Halliburton got it from Heal. And it's Hayward guarding Halliburton.
Get it back to Halliburton. Yeah, you can see you have to get it back to Halliburton to get into something.
Here's a long three.
Deep three!
He got it, he's got
deep three! You can see that leaving his hand. That is a deep three!
He has matched his career high with 43. 7 of 11 from three-point range.
He also recognized his teammates needed him to go to work.
And Bruce Brown is called for the foul.
I mean, that was a deep three. Look, he's out here. A step inside the blue on the logo and just let it fly.
Tyrese Halliburton made 10 last year en route to a 43-point game in Miami. Pacers down two. Ball. And Williams to the free throw line where he is 7 of 7. All five Charlotte starters in double figures, led by the 23 of Hayward, the 23 of Williams, and Rozier, who left with an injury, has 22. And Halliburton tying his career high 43. What a night.
I'm telling you, 8-12 from the three-point line.
Mark Williams shot just 69% from the free throw line last year. Came in tonight 8 of 11. And he is 7 of 7.
So you're working all the magic you can, aren't you?
They are perfect, Quint. You're right.
Working all the magic
that
you
announcer.
Can. Yeah, that jinx.
They are 22 of 22 at the line.
Oh, I knew they had missed a foul shot. So you thinking this is the one?
I thought that about 10 times tonight.
Well, I'm telling you, his is touching nothing but the net.
Yeah, his had been pure. 2.5 to play, 123-119. Fourth clutch game of the year for the Pacers. They're 2-1.
Give it up, give it up, give it up. Yeah, there you go, give it up.
Halliburton.
Missed it. There you go. I'll take what comes with that. I'll take what comes with that. But they're challenging him out of the three-point line, and he's got to drive it.
That called in for Buddy. Heald has 17. 2 minutes to play. 2-point Charlotte lead. Ball. He missed everything.
Did he hit the backboard? If he hit the backboard, he can catch it. If he did not, you're absolutely right. That's travel. Didn't hit the backboard.
And now he's down.
Well, I'd like to see if it hit the backboard. Yeah, he can catch that.
And he commits the foul. It is the fifth. Let's check that. Is it the fifth? It is.
Yeah, it's the fifth.
And so free throws now for the Pacers to tie it. Aaron Nesmith at the free throw line. Tough night, just 3 points. He struggled at the free throw line last night. He was just 2 of 4.
Plenty of time. I mean, you need to make the foul shot, but you got plenty of time.
1 of 2 for Nesmith. It's a 1-point game. 123-122 Charlotte. Hayward's had a 13-point second half. He missed it. And the Pacers will have it in the hands of Tyrese Haliburton.
Thank goodness he got it across. And I mean, he got it across for the second.
Down one.
But he's deep. He got it. Ooh. He was as deep as Tyree.
Yeah, he was, I think, were his feet on the blue?
Yeah, he was just, I think, in order to finish it, this guy, he loaded it.
Ball lobs it up, and it's tipped in by Williams.
I don't know how he got to that, because that ball was almost off the back.
1 minute to play. Pacers down 3.
See, that's what they've done differently. They've run some big people out there.
Skip, Turner threw it away. It was intended for Haliburton. And now P.J. Washington loses it, picks it back up. Oh, they're going to give it to Charlotte.
I think they called timeout. I think they called timeout.
37 4/10. Pacers do not have a challenge.
No, that is,
they do have a challenge.
Yeah, they got a challenge. They got it back.
That's right, Dave.
And they're going to get this ball. Pacers are going to get this ball.
That
ball
review, Kirkland. The ruling on the floor has been overturned. The ball is awarded to Indiana. This was their second charge timeout of the period, and it is a successful challenge. So, therefore, Indiana will still be charged with timeout.
Heald, Nesmith, Haliburton.
Now, they got Miller out there, and they're hoping for a switch.
Into the corner. Heald. He's going to go to the basket, and a blocking foul, and a chance for a 3-point play. Buddy Heald, known for 3-point shooting, a chance for 3. 22 threes on the night, but this from 15 feet to tie it. He missed it.
No, it's off the back of Williams. Yeah, that's off the back of Williams because Miles made a great effort.
So Heald misses, but the Pacers with 28 3/10 have it.
This is what should be a... Oh, my goodness. They got timeout. How did they get timeout? The ball was in the air. Yeah. They got timeout. The ball was in the air.
Rick,
can you get a 24-second count? I mean, a 5-second count.
LaMelo Ball got it. He's on the move. P.J. Washington stripped. Saved, and it's Pacers ball.
You gotta love this. You absolutely have to love this. They pushed the ball up the score.
Tyrese Haliburton, 15 9/10.
Okay.
Pacers down 1.
Let them switch it. Take ball.
16,000 on their feet.
They're not going to double team him. Oh, he mishandled the ball. He mishandled it. Oh, my goodness. And got ripped.
The rebounding, Boston, not just good with the raw numbers, but also in the rate stats. Top 10 in offensive and defensive rebounding rate this year.
Tyler's top 10 in every category. That's good.
Pretty much. Tatum on the step back. Got it.
Chuck Vaughn applauding his team's commitment to the three.
Here's Jaylen Brown. First real touch for him tonight. Finds Tatum on the stuff. By Porzingis, that's two stuffs for KP in the first 3 minutes. Tatum against Bridges. Great matchup here. Right over the top, in your eye hole. Glad that didn't work out.
I'm just saying, I don't hear him talking about crypto now.
Missed both free throws. You don't sponsor a crypto company? I'm surprised by that.
Oh, come on, Drew.
All right, I'm back. Tatum for three. You bet.
There you go. I'll pay him.
With seven to shoot, Bridges catches.
Oh, this is easy.
Tatum, that's barbecue chicken against Cam Thomas.
Whatever you want to call it. It could be any blip.
Brown wins the tap back to Holiday. If you watch Dennis Smith Jr. play at NC State, you know he's got bunnies. He can get up there. Tatum cyclones in and scores, plus the foul.
Pure muscle. Spin, finish, through contact. And one.
It'll be the third fastest in franchise history to hit that mark. Paul Pierce did it in 431. Larry Bird did it in 436. But Jason Tatum, the youngest Boston Celtic ever with 10,000 career points. For the half for the Celtics here. Porzingis with three. Out to Tatum. One dribble. Oh, yeah! Tatum beats the buzzer. And it's a 70 spot in the first half for the Celtics.
Dude, I don't think he trusted Smith was going to shoot that.
Hauser tries to answer. Tatum drills it.
I'm going to give Brissett a lot of credit on that play, keeping that ball.
Under six to play. Celtics by seven. Thomas all up in Tatum's business. That's a personal matchup. Tatum for three. You bet! Woo-hoo! Heat check time.
I mean, the guy stays hot as he flexes to the crowd.
That's a weight room bucket.
Oh, Jock
Vaughn. Look at this.
Jock Vaughn heated
all over.
He's gone for those 50 games. His first game was against Atlanta, and John Collins had a great ball game. What a finish by Rudy.
Patience. Still getting used to his new teammates both on and off the floor.
Mid-range.
Horton Tucker lost it on the way to the rim. Towns picks it up. Wolves on the prowl. Edwards wants three. Money.
What a good start for Minnesota.
McDaniel's out there with two fouls. We'll see if Kyle Anderson comes off the bench soon. Mid-range again. Edwards starting this game red hot. Conley caught in the air. Gives it to Anderson. Edwards using a Gobert screen. Stays hot.
So he's pretty clearly on the line. Pat Frere right there, too. I'm surprised he called that a three.
Horton Tucker, the floater, can't hit. And Gobert clears it.
Ant is in there. So much more defensive rebounding. Minnesota gang rebounding and actually boxing out now. Ant nestles one in.
Largest lead for the Jazz is three. Naz Reid will check in. Next dead ball. Edwards flying in. Left hand lay. Edwards has only missed one shot so far tonight. The pull up off glass. Edwards. Euro. Reverse. Plus the foul.
sensational.
Because he's gotten better at finishing around the rim, too. I mean, the way he uses the English that time to spin it off the glass. But the last basket, too, at the angle on the right side, kissing it off the glass. And, you know, I asked Sport Radar.
How about Towns, Gobert, and Reed out there at the same time as Anthony Edwards?
Minnesota had Utah down as Gobert gets the lob and took that time. What a pass by Ant from the top of the circle. Epic inside. He's tried to shoot those shots before.
Wolves looking for their second victory in a row ahead of Monday's matchup with Boston. McDaniels outside. Edwards. Boom!
They held Toronto to 97 points. They just could not stop them in transition. A lot of it was offensive inefficiencies. The same ones that happened as Anthony Edwards gets a driving layup there. You know, sometimes you got to learn a hard lesson, and sometimes these coaching points come through.
Oh, the steal. Highlight. Oh, the windmill.
Anthony's winding it up, baby. Getting out into the passing lane, taking that reversal pass and throwing it down. Ant's done this his whole career in the NBA.
They dropped 155 on the Pacers a handful of days ago.
We know what's happened with Kristaps Porzingis as Ant makes an impossible shot.
A little better job yesterday afternoon in Philadelphia. Durant on a tough off-balance baseline shot over Stewart.
Safety op stayed down on him. He couldn't make a maneuver to get close to the rim.
Hayes wants to get that left hand. You can see KD trying to force him out of it. Burning a lot of time on the shot clock, and that's smothered chicken on a Sunday afternoon for Kevin Durant. Coming off a season-high 11 assists. He does have a propensity to turn it over, though, as Durant, tough leaner, and got the tougher finish. Durant takes the handoff. Gets past Durant, glides in for the lay-in.
He's moving really good.
Thompson just driving past him, threw an elbow into his chest, didn't get called with a foul, up ahead of the Suns on a break. Durant rising up and taking him.
I just love the fact the Suns are getting some good looks. Their energy is really good. That's off of a back-to-back, and that's huge.
Durant turns the corner inside with the finish. Durant with a rebound, up ahead now to Thompson. Thompson flying in, and second block of the afternoon for Kevin Durant. Going back, Cunningham tied up. Good defense, stolen away by Durant. KD with a ball fake, off the elbow, got it. Suns biggest lead, 15. Catch and shoot three coming from Durant, splash down. Again, taking a little more pressure off of Kevin Durant and Eric Gordon, who has set the scoring pace thus far today.
He's got six rebounds, though. So he is doing some good things, right? And he's not forcing shots.
First three-point knocked out of the afternoon for Hayes, who has struggled with his three-point shooting at 28%. Eric Gordon lines it up and knocks it down. Detroit's hit a couple of here in the third. Suns with three. Durant on the crossover with a pull-up. Money.
Told you. Like, you better block it, because if you don't, they were gonna be upset.
Durant on the fade and a little pretty spin. Spins away from defensive help. Watanabe on the baseline drive. He's tied up. Durant with five on the shot clock. KD, little sidestep jumper. Got it. Durant working on Stewart. Raising up from deep. Connects in the face of the defender. A long two for Durant. They're 15. As we said, these two teams lead the league in turnovers as Durant inside and brings the boom.
Now they connect. They've been trying that for the last two games.
J.O. flies in like Superman off the right wing, grabbing the offensive rebound. KD with the finger roll and a 40 piece.
Go on and get that little 40 piece. That little 40. That 40.
1.8 on the shot clock. Oh. Johnson. I mean, they only had 1.8. And they executed. Scotty up fake on the drive.
take it back when you take a look at it over and over.
Barnes, the first fourth quarter, Scotty B.
And energy, most important. It started with that energy. Going out, getting rebounds. Rebounds that was out of his area, still going to go get them.
New turnovers as well. 2:40 to go, 5-point game. Osmond sends it to Wemby. Guarded by Scotty. Here comes the help with OG. Corner three doesn't go. Tremendous job defensively by Barnes and the Raptors against Wembanyama. Now attacking. A stutter step. OG back up top to Schroeder. Schroeder puts up a shot. And he'll hit.
Job of getting all the way to the basket. Created that foul. Put himself at the free.
19 for Schroeder. Now 20. Coming into this game, three consecutive triple-doubles. Reached that today, three dimes, but he's got 20 points. He's got double-doubles in four of the last five. 2 minutes to go.
2 minutes.
And a foul is going to be charged. 5 years of age. First free throw good. Open things up for Zach Collins.
And it's going to open things up for Wemby as well, because he's a guy that can extend a bit, but he's physical. He can guard the other bigs, physical bigs, and Wemby doesn't have to do that until he starts putting more muscle on and then have to create more endurance. So they complement each other well.
Count the bucket. It's a two-point game with 1:45 to go. Collins, his third season here in San Antonio, coming off of an ankle injury. First 3 years in Portland, denied by Barnes. Scooped up by Wemby. He whips it in the corner to Johnson, and Johnson rattles it. Schroeder into the front court. Leaves it for Scotty. Barnes backs up, now over to Schroeder. Scotty attacking right to the iron. He's got 25 now.
And that's what's happening. Scotty's expanded his game. You got to respect the three ball a bit. That time Wemby stood up just a little bit, Scotty blew right by him with a two-hand flush.
Another minute to go. Johnson pulls up. Shot doesn't go, and a chance here for Toronto. Cut it to one or tie. Schroeder backs it out into the hands of Scotty B. To tie it. Barnes delivers. 108-108.
And I mentioned it, that last time he had to respect the three. He drove by. Now they're expecting to drive by, and he pulls up with a dagger.
Fans rising to their feet in San Antonio. 108-108. Barnes has got 28. What a game. Collins on the inside. Strip, double, jump ball. 2.6 remaining up. Schroeder and Jones positioning themselves. Johnson out of bounds. And a foul is going to be called. A foul is going to be called against Toronto.
Foot-to-foot contact by Siakam to Johnson has been deemed illegal, and there's nothing clear and conclusive to overturn the ruling on the floor. Therefore, this is an unsuccessful challenge. The foul remains on Siakam, and there's two free throws.
Opportunity. First free throw good. Johnson makes both. 110-108. San Antonio with a foul to give. Scotty, Schroeder for the win. Schroeder in and out. Wemby, loose ball scooped up. OG ties it. 110-110. Timeout, San Antonio. Pass stolen, timeout. Scotty. And there should be some time. Schroeder, Barnes, Siakam, and OG. Here's Scotty turning, firing. overtime. Here's Pascal attacking. Finds Jakob, gets it back, pulls it out to the wing. Working with Hurdle. And backs in on Collins. Jakob finishes. It's a contact, no call.
Just being aggressive, going to the rack, finishing. Hurdle's right there to clean up the mess.
Hurdle with a double-double performance and his return to San Antonio. Johnson to Collins. Seven on the shot clock. Collins attacking with a left. Raptors by three.
Good defense by Hurdle.
What a difference, the second half. Now into OT. Career best. OG. Seven made threes.
Keeping that energy up, sticking to the script defensively, and sharing the ball offensively and not turning it over.
You mentioned zero turnovers. Raptors have 83 points since halftime. That's their most ever scored in the second half and overtime in a franchise history. Bucket for Wembanyama.
And this young Spurs team already in this early season, they have been in some situations against the Phoenix Suns, so they're not going to get rattled.
Schroeder. Jumper good. Well, what did Wembanyama, I mentioned this earlier, what did he say about the league, what he's learned through five games? He said, the biggest thing I've learned is a 20-point lead is nothing. And guess what? They led by 22.
Yes.
Wembanyama turns, fires. The three doesn't go. Barnes with a rebound. Scotty now over to Poeltl. Siakam with it. Barnes with another double-double this season. Pascal up top. Siakam getting downhill with a left. Doesn't go. Batted out. Poeltl. Tremendous effort by Jakob.
Just being physical, fighting in there. That time he was the lone man in there for the Raptors, and he got his hand on the ball.
Johnson takes it away from Shooter. Numbers. Trey up top. Four-point game.
What a floater by Jones. We know Scotty can go up there and go get it. Jones with a nice touch. Got to watch a double.
Barnes nearly.
And it's at certain points of the game.
Schroeder into the backcourt. Wembanyama draped all over him. The cut. Pascal in traffic. Porter. Shot clock down. Wembanyama got a piece of it. And a shot clock violation. Four-point game, 35.9 remaining in overtime. Raptors coming in have won five in a row against San Antonio.
But, Matt, I'm not mad at that play. Of course, you didn't get the shot off, but you wore the whole shot clock down. So it's still a two-possession game. So you wasted time off the clock. So not a totally bad possession by the Raptors.
Wembanyama, deep three. And it rolls out. Barnes with his 11th rebound. And a foul. Him to inbound it. Schroeder. Pressure. He'll break it into the front court. Raptors by four. Two possession game. And a foul. And OG knocking down threes. And Scotty taking over in the fourth.
And that was it. They gave themselves a chance from the defensive side. You know, I know you get tired of hearing me talk about defense, but that.
Fourth quarter beat. Raptors up by five. Bank shot doesn't go, and that's going to do it. Pascal Siakam. Siakam out on the run. Siakam with it. Sends it now over to OG. OG playing keep away to Scotty. And what a victory for the Toronto Raptors. For the largest halftime and finding the right combinations for Darko Rajakovic, and I'm sure he'll look back on this game and say, okay, we finished great, but did not like the way it started. And Greg Popovich embraces Darko Rajakovic and says, great job.
Here tonight as Garland works his way to the paint, floats it up, left it short. Allen corrals the offensive rebound. Back to Mitchell for three. He knocks it down. Thompson saunters into the forecourt where he's met by Strus. Plays through Looney. Catch and shoot. Steph Curry.
sees his first action for the Cavs.
Yeah, he's been playing well, and their bench has been pretty productive.
Allen off the Mitchell feed. He lays it in.
Keep the ball moving.
Wiggins steps into a mid-range jumper. That's tipped by Niang. Gets it back. Curry fakes, fires, and scores.
Because even though they aren't a big team, they're a very good rebounding team.
Tristan Thompson has checked into the Cavs. That's Mitchell to the basket. He lays it up and in. Meanwhile, Chris Paul has taken the floor for the Warriors. The 38-year-old is in his 19th season as Curry shifts to his left and Kansas' third three of the opening quarter.
Well, you can see when you challenge them out front, it's a nice opportunity to stop them on offensive end.
Cavaliers a 38-35 lead as we pass the midway point of the second quarter. Curry has four threes.
Yeah, you can't be late.
Looney dumps off to Green. Green late in the shot clock. Plunks one off the backboard. That's rebounded by Mobley.
Cavaliers will not give up on a defensive end. Continue to defend.
Mitchell for three. Accelerates to the foul line. Opens up Strus. The long rebound tracked down by Mitchell. He'll just fire it and hit.
He said, well, I'll let you try it, Max.
Klay Thompson off to Green. Green down the lane. Dumps off to Payton. Payton flips it up. Missed the shot. It's tapped out to Mitchell. Boy, the Cavs dodge the bullet there as Mitchell works to the basket around Klay Thompson and lays it up and in. Misses that three. He hit four in the first half. Mitchell, what a move right around Klay Thompson as Mitchell took it over the top of Klay and round to the basket.
He loves to make that little move there where he'll take that dribble, you reach for it, he takes it up over your hand right there, and he's always at the basket from there, but he plays what's in front of him.
Klay Thompson off the Draymond Green. Green hit two threes in the first half, missed that one, gets it back off a Looney rebound. Don't let that man shoot. Curry now has five. The Bucks and the Clippers are older as Mobley skies for the rebound. 9:20 remains third quarter. The Cavalier lead is nine. A no-look pass finds Allen. Oh, what a dandy of a pass by Mitchell.
Running the floor.
This season, move the ball better, move bodies. Garland off to Mitchell. Mitchell, got it.
Woo-hoo. Cavaliers on the move.
Curry. He doesn't miss many of those either as Steph Curry connects once again. Jackson Davis returns to Curry. Curry's badgered by Strus. Curry looking to set up back. Steps to his right and hits.
Boy, he is unbelievable, isn't he? And there's nothing you can do about that.
Curry now has 26. There's not much you can do about that either. Garland scurries into the forecourt, finds the trailer. It's Mitchell for three.
Donovan Mitchell from his partner Garland.
Coming down on the break, right into his partner's arms and knocking it down.
Steps back. That's rebounded by Mobley. Well defended by the Cavs. Strus leaks out, makes the catch and puts it in.
Wiggins had no idea what a ball was. That's when you have mobility and everybody has mobility, the size will win out.
Curry tried to draw a foul. He doesn't get it.
So they have the advantage inside because of the size.
Mitchell takes the Allen handoff, puts it up and in.
Kyrie, one of the best handles in the league. He's going to get to his spot. Get it. There you go.
Soft touch for the 7'1" Mark Williams. Hornets won two in a row last year against the Mavericks. Score the goal, Gordon Hayward. Loose. Here comes LaMelo. Streaking down the floor. To the rim. Gordon Hayward rings the bell.
About the setup by LaMelo. LaMelo, look at this. I mean, there's Jones Jr. had no idea what LaMelo was going to do with the ball. Gordon did. Get up and get it. 20, still got some bounce.
DJ rolls. That has become his sweet spot.
Nice play right there. You got Exum.
During that portion of the season, the Mavericks were still trying. Remember, this is a Mavericks team that got fined by the NBA for tanking. Cost them $750,000. Tough bill to swallow.
And the foul was the reason why he could not make it look really like that.
Well, we'll try it again and do it.
Got to give him two.
Gordon Hayward, first one to the rim. Again, taking advantage of Grant Williams.
Trying to win a back-to-back days to finish off this road trip. KO got a layup somehow.
Should get back, stop the ball, and find the shoe. At least get a hand up.
LaMelo's not made a shot today. There's his first.
What else you want?
Uses the left hand to finish. Doncic. Got caught in the air, nowhere to go. This has not been vintage Doncic. Southpaw slam. Good old number 25.
PJ Washington. Look at LaMelo bounce it to him. Right past Kyrie and threw over around our guy Grant Williams. Man, that was, especially in that short corner.
LaMelo's got 12 assists. Sneaks that one in with a left hand and a foul.
Much less over the rim. Look at this. He's behind the backboard. Look at the spin he put on that ball. Okay, can you hold Dallas off the last 220 of this quarter? That'll do it.
LaMelo Ball, all three of his baskets have been layups. Just getting started in our fourth quarter, and absolutely nothing's been decided. LaMelo hasn't hit an outside shot today. But the fourth quarter just hits different.
What do you want?
Limping back to the bench.
Right there. Didn't like that first shot. Give it back to BJ. A little two-man game and step.
LaMelo. Center of the court looking for help. LaMelo! Some newfound strength for the kid. Chance for a three-point play.
Screen, that gives him a straight line drive. Look at the Hezzy right there. Freezes Luka and gets by
him. Oh, Luka just got a technical foul. What a boneheaded play. And the Hornets. PJ. LaMelo, his third three-pointer here in the second half.
How about that?
LaMelo, again! This kid's nails!
His new teammate.
Students at Providence State getting a charge out of the performance by Grant Williams. Left-handed layup, a beauty! LaMelo lands hard. Hopefully he's okay. Gordon. Long rebound, LaMelo. Significant rebound for LaMelo. That gives him 10. Woo! From Wakahachi! In 21 attempts.
Grant Williams had hit three triples in this quarter. Be a different story.
Hard to keep a Charlatan down. Woo! Oh, my goodness. Circus shot, LaMelo Ball.
Good start for him.
Fifth year for him out of Duke. First with the Lakers, former top 10 pick, as Leonard hits from mid-range.
Well, that's what he does, Dave. He can do that whenever.
Been a little bit of a struggle for him in comparison to how he played last year, which earned him that big contract. Great hands by George to get the steal. And here's Highland in transition. No Terrence Mann tonight. He has yet to play this season with an ankle injury. So, Bob, you touched on the passing of James Harden. That's got to take a lot of pressure off of not just Kawhi Leonard, Paul George, and Westbrook as well, I would assume.
But they've been a heavy isolation.
Another miss from deep from LeBron James, taking now 25 threes in just four-plus games this season. Leonard from deep. That's good. And Kawhi, who struggled shooting last night. Basket by Bones Highland, his second field goal. Westbrook pokes it away from Reeves. Second turnover by Reeves already. Leonard with the hot hand. He's 4 for 4 and 2 of 2 from behind the arc, and the Clippers lead by 7. Porter, a career high for the opening quarter for Leonard. Year 13 in the league, playing on a back-to-back.
They're putting Leonard a lot in this pick and roll. He's on fire. This guy. They may have to change up something because they're going under the screen, or at least not making a great. Leonard, like I said, last possession, AD didn't stand for it. But right here, he laid back a little too far and just enough room.
It's just such a small gap. I mean, Denver's the reigning champ. You might say they have a lead as far as on what they've accomplished, but all these other teams are kind of jumbled up.
George with a floater. It's good. And you were kind enough to tell Darvin Ham that...
Obviously, I was joking.
Yes, and he knew you were joking, but he was thankful nonetheless. As Leonard gets to the rim, counted and a foul. Kawhi with 15 points, 6 of... in the opening quarter against the Lakers.
And even had a great world championships with Steve Kerr and that staff. It's not who he is, I can tell you that. He's a better player than he showed early in this season.
Lakers 2 for 9 from 3. Leonard hits another 3 and a career high for first quarter scoring.
This is, like I said, it's too easy right now, right? That's a warm-up 3.
You got Leonard off the ball being guarded by LeBron James. Now on the switch, George, step back 3 over Reeves. That's good. And the lead is 7.
This is just elite one-on-one skill. Nothing you can do. A tough shot there. Paul George, good player.
He's out again tonight. It's an ankle injury. He played in 81 games each of the last 2 seasons. Normally very reliable. There's a 3 from Paul George. Boy, the Clippers with Kawhi Leonard back in the game. They're plus 22 tonight.
Finding out what they are. I mean, they could have that same team next year. They could break the whole thing up. I mean, based on this year, like you said, Dave.
And they don't have the draft capital anymore as Kawhi Leonard drills it. That's his first field goal of the second quarter.
Arguably the third best player. Look for them to get him going here.
Just 2 points, 5 assists, but 5 turnovers for Reeves. Here's Paul George, who had 9 points in the first half. Took only 4 shots, and he knocks that one down to start the third quarter. He showed you Russell West of the game. George being defended by Reddish, who gets the late call to start because of a pregame. 3 minutes gone by in the third. Clippers by 11. They led by 19 in the first quarter, thanks to Kawhi Leonard, who gets to the basket way too easily. Those first-round picks, are those going to matter?
Well, depends on, you know, you want them to matter, certainly, but the teams that are trading, they're
to play in the third.
He needed that, and the team needed that, and maybe that'll get Reeves going.
Leonard with Christie on his hip goes right at him and puts it up and in. That's the 28th point for Kawhi Leonard tonight. Take a 3-point lead.
Yeah, look, Wood's giving him some good minutes here. Reeves has woken up. Christie's doing his best. Reddish stepped in as a starter in this game, but really the effort has been so much greater here in the second half. That's what the Clippers might have needed. You know, a tough shot. The ball has not been going in. You know his tendencies, but he made a big shot there. Easy one for him, I suppose.
George for 3 again. Hits again. Back-to-back triples by Paul George.
Passing away at 83. Back now to L.A., Dave Pasch, Bob Myers, George Sedano. Gentlemen.
All right, Scotty. Kawhi Leonard up to 30 points now with that basket. And if... he has 29 points now. Paul George drills another triple. That's his 5th. He's got 25 points. Kimura, no Jared Vanderbilt. Torian Prince is out as well, as is Gabe Vincent. Great hang and finish by Paul George to go. Paul George got 5 threes in the game. He's got Anthony Davis on him. He gets past him, and he's fouled by Davis. Count the basket, and a chance at a 3-point play, which would pull the Clippers within 3.
He's so good at this. He got beat here, but his length, even when he gets beat like that, Dave, he can catch up, block you.
George. Clippers ball down 4. 9-second difference in the game in shot clocks. George, pull up 3, buries it, and gets the Clippers within 1. There's a 10th of a second difference. Now there's not, so...
we keep talking about hard. It's hard to live on this stuff, but when they're going in, it's pretty fun.
Westbrook, 24 points, 10 rebounds, handful of steals. He's had a great night. Here's Leonard, was hot in the first quarter, and gets going here in overtime. 32 points. Remember, he had 18 in the first quarter.
Shot he makes most of the time.
I mean, when is the last time he played 72 minutes in 24 hours? As we say that, he gets a big shot through contact, finishing, getting the basket.
He's so good. He's so strong. And Anthony Davis is not easy. These shots, they're contesting the heck out of his shots, by the way. The ones he missed, that left wing 3, this green and roll, and that's just giving the Lakers a pretty clean look when they want it.
Here's Leonard, step back 3. On the money!
Kawhi Leonard gets the Clippers within a point. Leonard has 38.
7 turnovers, 11 points. And the Raptors are shooting just 36% from the field. Scotty turns, fires three. Good. And his three-point shooting has really improved. Highest five-man unit in the NBA. They're plus 31. That's Schroeder, Poeltl, Siakam, Barnes, and Ananobi. Can they get Pascal going? They're looking for Jakob.
Then the Raptors are coming out offensively with a designated play. They got them a bucket. Defensively, they had a deflection. It just didn't fall in their hands. So great approach starting this.
The Raptors have missed just one shot here early in this third.
They've been dishing it and attacking again, another dish. And Poeltl is eating. He's finishing his breakfast. That time Schroeder, that time Scotty Barnes. Pat San Antonio, just like a Barnes, break him down a little bit, drop it off, finish it, tag
you know
up a little
at halftime?
Bit. McDermott, 5 in the shot clock and a turnover. Malachi to Scotty, and he's fouled. The finish.
Good defense by the Raptors. The Spurs were doing a nice job of getting the ball, passing it around, but the Raptors being solid on defense and getting out to the
real.
And you see that play developing. He's coming off a screen. He back cut to go to the basket and just threw it up there. Had the awareness to find his teammate. Good job by Scotty Barnes. Being patient, being in rhythm.
Got a chance here to get it within range, and there's Trent Jr. with a 3 and a timeout. Greg Popovich.
Scotty get an opportunity. Wimby can't get out there. Gary Trent Jr. ready. Feet set, locked and loaded. 3 ball.
In fourth quarter scoring in the NBA. Dick gets it away from Wimby. Clock down. Finds Barnes, and the 3 is good.
What a pass by the young fella, Matt. Went for that steal. He's doing a nice job of staying in front.
Scotty connects. He has made a 3.
G-Matt, defensively, they've been getting stops, and then they've been being aggressive, letting the shots come.
In and out. Barnes handles it. Scotty backing in.
Bucket.
Power move! Game after San Antonio led by 22. Schroeder into the front court, leaves it for Scotty. Barnes backs up, now over to Schroeder. Scotty attacking right to the iron. He's got 25 now.
And that's
the jump ball.
You see Scotty with the blow by.
Cut it to one or tie. Schroeder backs it out into the hands of Scotty B to tie it.
A bit. Now, guess what? You're going to respect the blow by, and I don't care where you are. I'm going to step back a little bit.
Pass stolen, timeout. Scotty. And there should be some time added to it.